pound town in our town. This is our Rumble Beast pregame show for tonight. As a prologue for this evening's FPHL West Division encounter featuring the Battle Creek Rumble Bees as they clash with the Danville Dashers. This is game number two for both of these teams as the return to pro hockey in Battle Creek concludes this opening weekend. We've made history this weekend with the return of Battle Creek professional hockey here and morning a new era in Battle Creek and professional hockey annals. For the Rumble Bees making their pro debut this weekend, as it's been a hockey happening here in Battle Creek with the return of professional hockey, FPHL style through the Rumble Bees. Tonight, the Rumble Bees and the Dashers wrap up a two-game homestand series here at the rink. It's game number two of 57 outings for Battle Creek and their second of 24 home appearances at the rink. All 24 games in a very appealing schedule are staged on weekends, including three Sunday matinee affairs. Tonight, Battle Creek plays its second in a season opening extended five-game homestand. In fact, head coach Clint Hagmeyer's contingent is actually broaching their first ever fledgling franchise season by playing eight of their first nine games here at the amiable climes and environs of the rink in Battle Creek. Tonight, Battle Creek and Danville will lock antlers for the second of 11 meetings this season and the second of only three that'll be waged here in Battle Creek. Today, both these teams wrap up their brief two-game schedules in October. And for the Rumble Bees, both games at home, both against Danville, both in the final weekend of the month of October. Clint Hagmeyer, the Pittsburgh native, in his first season as a professional coach. Hagmeyer did serve as a coach in the junior and midget age groups for many years before his advent here to Battle Creek in the Serial City. The Rumble Bees are one of four new expansion franchises adorning the FPHL this season as the Federal Prospects League celebrates a dawn of a decade. This is their 10th anniversary season, and this season the league has expanded from 6 to 10 clubs, including the Rumble Bees, the Columbus River Dragons, join Battle Creek at the second and final installment of this inaugural weekend two-game homestand weekend series against the Danville Dashers. Just the Rumblebees and Danville. We're back with more after we pause for a moment. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Fat One. Battle Creek, the pro hockey buzz is on, and you want to be here at the Beehive, the rink Battle Creek. This is Terry Ficcarelli. Rumblebees season tickets, single game tickets are on sale now. Catch the buzz of Rumblebees pro hockey action. For tickets, 269-243-5027. Go to beehockey.com or any social media platform at BC Rumblebees. It's Rumblebees Hockey.
Did you have the first Fleetwood Mac Rumors album? I wore out my first one. Fleetwood Mac, one of the best-selling bands of all time. We couldn't get enough. They took 50 years of music and made their Don't Stop collection. They're making a final stop of Fleetwood Mac's World Tour in Vegas, too. You can catch them November 16th and all weekend long. 102.7 The Fat One is showcasing Fleetwood Mac. It's magnificent.
Terry Ficcarelli rejoining Ohio for the rink Battle Creek. Downtown in our town tonight. Hockey night in Battle Creek. Saturday night goal. It's the second and concluding game of the two-game homestand inaugural weekend series featuring the Rumblebees as they lock antlers with the Danville Dashers. Rumblebees roster to begin the season as a distinct American influence. 15 players that adorn its roster are from the U.S. There are 5 Canadians and 2 Swedish imports. In the meantime, as for Danville, the Dashers return a dozen players from last season's team that failed to qualify for the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. In fact, Danville finished tied for 5th in the team's 6-team circuit with Mentor, with a record of 16-36-7 for 58 points. They were the lowest scoring team in the circuit. They surrendered the 4th most goals against. In fact, the Dashers until last night and all of last season had the dubious distinction of registering the worst power play in the league last season. In fact, their penalty killing unit wasn't much better. It was also ranked rather ghastly, dastardly 7th and last in the league last campaign. This is a Danville team that has demonstrated vast improvement under the direction of its head coach, Ray Tremblay, the native of Peachland, British Columbia. We expect Danville to operate with its same lineup. Absolutely overwhelming, overpowering against this Battle Creek team that at times appeared to be somewhat manhandled. But as head coach Clint Hagmeyer states coming up on our pregame show, he felt that perhaps his team had the opening night jitters, that they were somewhat timid and taciturn, and because this was new exposure for them. For many on this young hockey club, many are rookies. Many of them, of course, experienced their first ever professional hockey game. We expect Jake Mullen to receive his second straight starting goal tonight for Battle Creek. The 6'3", 191-pound angular, elongated netminder, hails from Idaho. He played last season in Sweden. Mullen expected to receive the starting goal tonight for the Rumblebees. His counterpart will be Harley White. White makes his first appearance of the season for head coach Ray Tremblay's visiting Dashers as winning netminder last night. Jesse Gordichuk receives the night off. He'll be the understudy while Joel Eisenhower, the 24-year-old first-year pro from Lebanon Valley State, will serve likewise as the understudy tonight for head coach Clint Hagmeier's contingent here at the rink, Battle Creek. Rumblebees look to salvage a split in their first ever weekend of hockey professionally in Battle Creek. They look to salvage a split in this two-game homestand inaugural weekend series against the Danville Dashers. After tonight, the Rumblebees will continue this extended five-game homestand to launch their first season with two more home games next weekend here at the rink, Battle Creek. Again, it's another Friday night, Saturday night combination at 7:35 p.m. The Mentor Icebreakers of the East Division, just outside of Cleveland, Ohio, will be guested by the Rumblebees here next Friday and Saturday nights at 7:35. Rumblebees season tickets and single game tickets are on sale now at the Rumblebees offices located right here at the rink, Battle Creek. Or phone the Rumblebees at 269-243-5027. Visit the Rumblebees online at bhockey.com or on any of the available social media platforms at BC Rumblebees. Also, this special programming note that every Rumblebees game this season is broadcast live right here on 102.7 FM, the Bat One, and 9:30 AM, the exclusive radio flagship home of the Rumblebees. Also, every game is broadcast on the live stream. Every game is broadcast live on the live stream at 1027WFAT.com, 1027WFAT.com. Just a quick listen now, and you're tuned up and tuned in on the live stream for all the electrifying, spellbinding action of Battle Creek Rumblebees Pro Hockey in this 2019-20 FPHL season. Tonight's action live from the rink, Battle Creek. It's Saturday night hockey. Hockey night in Battle Creek. It's Saturday night for the Rumblebees and Danville. And when we come back, head coach Clint Hagmeier will join us next. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
At Fox's Pizza Den in Battle Creek, they make the freshest, most delicious pizza, specialty hoagies, and mouthwatering scrumptious sides every day for their customers. They serve the absolute very best pizzas, strombolis, nearly world-famous wedgies, and gourmet pizzas. All of their meals are made with the finest ingredients and then baked to perfection. Always fast and friendly service. Fox's Pizza Den, Battle Creek. Order online for delivery or pick up at Fox's Pizza Den, battlecreek.com. 269-979-9869.
The Rink Battle Creek is the FPHL Pro Hockey home of our team, the Rumblebees. The Rink Battle Creek welcomes you to all of the lightning electric action of Rumblebees Hockey. The Rink Battle Creek has a deep desire to make quality ice time available to our great community, regardless of age, league affiliation, background, or capability. It's a fun, safe, clean environment where you're always welcome to join them for a game, open skate, community event, or sharpen your skating and hockey skills. The Rink Battle Creek, home of the Rumblebees. TheRinkBattleCreek.com.
I believe the guys got better as we went along through the bids. It just takes a little bit used to the speed, and didn't utilize our tools the way we needed to, but that's something part of the learning process, and we'll keep sticking to the process.
Was it a factor being a little bit nervous opening night jitters in front of a large crowd?
Oh, I think so, I mean, especially when you're a young guy who hasn't played in this league before or played at this level. It definitely takes a toll on the nerves, but we've got world-class guys. They're able to play. They'll mentally battle through it, that's for sure.
Danville's power play was especially lethal last night to the tune of 5 power play goals. You need to combat that tonight, and I would guess probably stay out of the penalty box would be a good start.
No, probably staying out of the penalty box always is a good start, right? It's always a good plan. Sometimes that doesn't go your way. We had a couple of unfortunate mishaps on penalties when that happens. Some not to our fault as well. But, you know, we had a pretty good penalty kill. You can't kill them all sometimes, even though you'd like to. But we did kill a lot of them, and we took only let up one on a 5-minute major. I was pretty proud of the boys for that one.
The game started off with the early penalty to Gino Minnie. That set the tone because they promptly proceeded to score their first of the 5 power play goals.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Gino was literally just signed the day before, and you know, fresh out of Oakland University, and really getting a taste for this league. And he'll figure it out real quick, and he figured it out as the game went along, that's for sure.
A highlight last night was Vinny Susi's power play goal late in the second period. He made a rather sleek silk satin individual effort, and he really snapped a wicked shot through a forest of legs to finally register the first goal in franchise history.
That was a heck of a shot, wasn't it?
Yeah,
it was beautiful, and it was extra special for me as well, and for him. I mean, his parents were in the stands. It's always nice when family's here to witness your first goal professionally.
He's from Pittsburgh like you?
He's Pittsburgh for me. I coached him in junior, so I've known him since he was 16, and I was real proud of him. It was a heck of a shot, and actually came right after I verbally blasted him for a play before that, and he made the adjustment and put the puck in the back of the net.
Let's talk about game 2 tonight, Coach. What are you looking for your club? I would think that you will appeal to their pride after what happened last night, and perhaps show a better effort, maybe even surprise this Danville team tonight.
I'd like to think so. Our guys didn't take that loss lightly. They're competitors, no matter what. First and foremost, they're definitely competitors, and they do not like to lose. Nobody does if you're at this level and want to play well at this level. But I believe they'll come out. We made some lineup adjustments, and we'll go see how it goes from there.
Talk about those lineup adjustments, Clint, as you get ready for game 2 here tonight.
Well, we got Malcolm Zander, a Swedish-born player. He's in the lineup as well as Kyle Quick, who's a unique skating individual, strong on his skates and his edges, and powerful down low with the puck. So we'll see what the Danville can handle with that.
You have one player suspended after last night's action. Bring us up to speed on that, too.
It was Cliff Ogle. He gives a league suspension for a match penalty, and that's the nature of the game, unfortunately, and it's was not something that was intentional by him, but wasn't a great play either.
From the coach's perspective, what do you want to see from your hockey club tonight after last night's setback?
I want to see the little attention to details, things, simple things, sticks on pucks, getting in shooting lanes, passes to the tape or, passes into areas that utilize our tools, which is our speed. We have a lot of speed on this team, and Danville did a good job of shutting down our speed last night by taking away time and space, but we have to find that time and space and be able to create our own by using our speed.
goaltending situation. Who gets their call tonight, Coach, for those big, bad Rumblebees?
Jake was solid last night. Even though the score didn't show it, he gave us a chance throughout every shift. Like I said, 5 power play goals out of 7 goals, and you take that away, it's a 2-1 game. Two totally different story then, right?
Yeah.
Jake will start tonight.
Good luck tonight, Coach.
All right. Let's get these guys.
Thanks, legend.
Thanks, Coach. It's head coach Clint Hagmeier. It's the Rumblebees in Danville. Back with more after we pause for a moment. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Fat One.
It's the best lunch place in town and right in the heart of downtown Battle Creek. The Barista Blues Cafe, 91 Michigan Avenue West, features a fantastic menu of American and Italian cuisine. This place is a diamond in the rough. Barista Blues Cafe is a great place to grab a quick bite or a quick lunch, and they always have great daily lunch specials. Enjoy a hot cup of coffee, great conversation, and a friendly smile. Locally owned and operated, Barista Blues Cafe is always focused on customer satisfaction. Barista Blues Cafe, come on in and join the fun.
Graphics To Go is here to help organize all of your promotional needs. We promise to deliver better ideas, better timing, better budgets through our exceptional staff of industry professionals. We provide promotional products and services that go above and beyond, making you and your business a major success. Graphics To Go can promise solutions before problems. They have merchandise apparel, mugs, glasses, office and desk accessories, and top tech equipment. At Graphics To Go, staying comfortable and complacent is simply not an option. Contact them at graphicstogoinc.com.
Jerry Pecorelli rejoining you live from the rink, Battle Creek, before tonight's action. The Rumblebees clash with Danville one more time. For the Rumblebees, not in uniform tonight, deactivated center Eli Kinsman, serving a one-game suspension, left wing Cliff Ogle. Reactivated tonight, left wings Kyle Quick and Malcolm Zander. Jake Mullen gets the starting goal again tonight for the Rumblebees. Though he was touched for 7 goals last night, he did face a 45 tough use slate from the victors from Danville, Illinois, making 38 saves. Mullen gets the call in goal for a second straight tonight, a start tonight for Battle Creek. As for Danville, their uniform, their lineup remains uniform. They remain intact. Same lineup as last night when they rubbed the Rumblebees 7-1. Starting in goal tonight will be Harley White. Jesse Gordachuk, the winning netminder last night, gets the night off. It'll be White in goal tonight for Danville and Mullen in goal tonight again for Battle Creek. Second of 11 meetings this season between these two teams, and the second of 3 here in Battle Creek. 8 of 11 clashes this season will be waged and staged in Danville. Last night, in a rather, shall we say, inauspicious debut, the Rumblebees were roasted by the Dashers 7-1 on the strength of 5 power play goals. A pair of goals in the first and second periods, crowned by a 3-goal unanswered siege in period 3. Playing assistant coach and scoring champion Justin Brosden had 2 goals and an assist, both his goals on the power play. Likewise, Patrick Selek had a pair of power play goals. Vince Susie scored the only goal for the vanquished Rumblebees also. On a Battle Creek power play, the Rumblebees rouch up 45-19, 21-8 alone in the third period. Elsewhere tonight on the FBHL, all the second and concluding games of 2-game series, Port Huron and Danbury. It'll be Columbus at Delaware, Carolina goes at Elmira, Watertown guest Mentor. Last night, all the road teams won. 5 games opening night, and all 5 of them saw the pouring ice invaders prevail, including here in Battle Creek, where the Rumblebees were roasted by Danville 7-1. In Delaware, the debuting Thunder were upended by Columbus 5-2. In Elmira, in Commissioner's Cup 2019 revisited, again it was Carolina besting the Enforcers 2-0. And Danbury, the premier appearance of the Danbury Hat-Tricks was spoiled by Port Huron. In overtime, the Prowlers prevailed 5-4 in Watertown. The Wolves were subdued by Mentor 3-1 all five games last night. Saw the Porn Ice Invaders ultimately prevail. You're tuned up and tuned in. Tonight's FPHL West Division encounter comes to you live from the rink, Battle Creek, downtown in our town. It's the Battle Creek Rumblebees clashing with the Danville Dashers. My name is Terry Peccarelli saying see you at game time on 102.7 FM, The Fat One. Battle Creek, the pro hockey buzz is on, and you want to be here at the Beehive, the rink, Battle Creek. This is Terry Ficcarelli. Rumblebees season tickets, single game tickets are on sale now. Catch the buzz of Rumblebees pro hockey action. For tickets, 269-243-5027. Go to BeeHockey.com or any social media platform at BC Rumblebees. It's Rumblebees hockey.
Supercuts is the chosen hair salon of your Battle Creek Rumblebees. With a variety of services, from consistent quality haircuts for men and women to a relaxing tea tree experience to color services at an affordable price, their hairstylists are some of the best trained in the business. Specializing in haircuts for men, you get in and out while still receiving excellent service, including a hot towel at the end of every haircut. They'll listen to you and will recommend a style and products that will help you look and feel good. No appointment necessary and open 7 days a week. Check in online. Supercuts, the chosen hair salon of your Rumblebees.
Catch the buzz, Battle Creek. Your pro hockey team is on the air. This is Battle Creek Rumblebees pro hockey action on 102.7 The Fat One and AM 930. Rumblebees hockey is presented by Allegra Marketing Print Mail, by Barista Blues Cafe, by Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, Fox's Pizza Den, Graphics to Go, Jimmy John's, Jack Pearl's Team Sports, Happy's Pizza, by Vandervoort Kristen Fisher Attorneys at Law, Kitchen Proper, JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, Griffin Grill and Pub, by The Rink Battle Creek, Supercuts, and by The Cricket Club. It's all the electrifying action of Rumblebees hockey on Battle Creek's 102.7 The Fat One. Now, live radio ice side, the voice of the Rumblebees, Terry Ficcarelli.
Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for joining us. The site is the Rink Battle Creek, all set for tonight's FPHL West Division encounter featuring the Battle Creek Rumblebees as they tangle with the Danville Dashers. The referees for tonight's game are Chris Hoy and Adam Fish, the linesman are Nick Schrippa and Barry Mead. Starting last for tonight's game for Danville and goal to our right will be Harley White on the defense with a combination of Bobby Killian and Alex Palmerville. The forward line to open tonight at center, Fred Haim. Left wing will be Justin Brosson. Right wing will be Tanner Hildebrand. For the Rumblebees and goal to our left will be Jake Mullen making his second consecutive start. Opening on the defense with a combination of Vinny Susi, who delivered Rumblebees' only goal last night. He'll be joined on the back line by Gino Minnie. The forward line at center, John Champlain. On left wing, Ryan Alves. Right wing will be Lee J. McGinnis. The referees are Chris Hoy and Adam Fish. The linesmen are Nick Schrippa and Barry Mead. Jake Mullen in goal to our left for the Rumblebees and Harley White in goal to our right for the Dashers. It's your look into your radio zone. 102.7 FM, the Fat One. All ready to go from the faceoff of the Rumblebee line on the left. Defense suits you cross circle. The silver mini up the right board to center for Alves. Floats it behind the goal. White sets it up there for Killian on the right board. Trey Hildebrand. Hildebrand on the right boards at his own line. Left it on the defense for Killian, sweeping it across circle to circle now for Palmerville. His pants halted at center by Min, who stepped up on the right defense, redirecting it back into the Danville zone. Killian is there to funnel it along the boards of to the Battle Creek line. Controlled by Champlain on right wing. He tried to gain the line. He was denied there by Hildebrand, but trailing the play is McGinnis. He'll drop it back right point for Minnie. Stepping out the pressure, though, was Jesse Nair as he sends it in behind the goal. Controlled by Nat. Left point, the shot was blocked and deflects into the Rumblebee zone. Tracked down with urgency by Minnie. He was short of the back wall by Rockoff, but covering up behind the goal is Siegel. Siegel now at his own line for Nat in the middle at center for Xander. Shooting, and that's right on White. The save, he'll hold. Genuflecting to his left. Adam pawing the puck with his catching glove with Xander in his debut. 6 foot 207, the rookie sweet left wing. As from center circle, he unleashed one. From the face up, just underway, first period game. Strollers, Danville controls it at the home line. Troy Murray on the defense. Weaves his way across from the left to the right side at center back in behind the goal. Single to cover. His pass halted center point, but failing to hold it in there was Barakoff. And the Danville defenseman will retreat with it and drop it off in front of his own goal. Controlled there by Seth and Zora, fly it in behind the goal. Tracked down behind their Rumblebees defense by Siegel. Siegel on right wing at his own line for Munson. Carl Munson through center of the Danville line with a shot, and he blazed it just wide. The rebound of the left circle. Nicoletti fired the shot, and he blazed that one wide. Deflects off the back wall all the way back behind the Rumblebees goal. Nicoletti is there. He was checked from behind, though, by Zylak through the rescue, though. On the left board for Battle Creek is McElroy Scott and the University of Jamestown first year pro. Will wrap it off the boards the length of the ice for icing against Battle Creek. No further play. We played 2:04 first period. Game scoreless face off as a result. Circle right of Jake Mullen in the Battle Creek goal. It'll be McElroy Scott on the faceoff at Zylak. Left point for Palmerville with a shot. He rang it off the post on the screenshot. Rebound of the Rumblebee left circle, controlled by Siegel. He raked it off the board. The center back comes Danville over the Battle Creek line. Now Zylak from the left wing corner trying to center when it was blocked at the top of the slot by Munson. Controlled on the left boards by Santelli. Now Santelli for Battle Creek on right wing. Had his own lapper McGinnis in the middle of center for Champlain. He'll just direct it into Danville territory. Danville controls on the right defense. There, Palmerville coming up board behind the goal. Both teams change. Scraped off the back wall behind the goal by Santelli. Leading on right wing at his own line for Ryan Elvis. He'll direct it in behind the Danville goal. Tracked down there on the defense by Murray right up the middle at his own line on the lead for Fred Hain, who's center at the end. Paddle Creek climb with a shot right on, and Mullen reached across and nabbed that one for the left-hand stab. No further play. Both teams setting a torrid tempo, a fast pace. Early in this contest, we played 3:01 of period one, and we're scoreless. Faceoff right of Mullen in the Battle Creek goal. From the face of the puck is airborne, and it flutters over the glass into the crowd below us and to our left near the Rumblebee's defensive right corner. The base of the curve circle right of Jake Mullen in the Rumblebee's goal. From the face off, it'll be from the draw, won by Danville. The Murray shot was right on as he fired from left point. The save by Mullen, puck the ball upwards for Kyle Quick. At center for Xander, a backhand into the Danville zone as net was dumped center circle by Hain. Puck now controlled deep and behind that Danville goal to our right by Troy Murray. Murray lost it to Nat, low right circle, the car deep net. Steering fans right in front, the suddenly materializing Shea Carey fired the shot. Chest ties tape, short side left post there by White. Now Carey again. Now Carey behind the goal. Remunson jumped off his stick, dug out left corner though by Nat. Nat steps left circle and fired the shot over top of the net. Rebound and Crowbar Danville, and they'll start out at center zone. Hain was halted there by Minnie, but trailing is Boston. Locomotives in over the Battle Creek, flying the Bronx, and shot over top of the net, and back on Battle Creek, they're away. Carey on left wing at center with an Anvil line on the left boards with the button hooking Munson. Munson dishes down low toward the left corner now for the Pure Wedding. Champlain left circle where Munson. Munson is around the defenseman on that side. Killian, who spilled him, but play goes right on. Contained left point by Nicoletti with a shot. That's right on. And White reached skybound and brought it down in the dam. Hill goal to our right. No further play. They run. Bumblebees with more energy. They seem to be a more vivified. Aroused aggregation through the first 4.5 minutes of this scoreless opening period. From the faceoff, Danville will control it its own line on left wing. Jesse Nair through center, speeds in with the battle. Great line. Right in front on the doorstep for Tesorio, and the shot was right on. And moment, point blank range. Bearded with a left-hand stab. No further play. Jake Mullen, who was supreme last night despite the seven-goal allotment. Again, with some flashing sub-leather larceny. On the face-off, puck deep in Rumblebee's territory from behind the goal. Santelli lassoes it on the left board. Out for Lee J. McGinnis, the Calgary native. Goes cross-eyes on right wing in his own line for the defense. Aaron Bessie will control the back behind the goal. Further retreat of Santelli in hot pursuit. But Barakov who stole it, and as Barakov was set around the net, it was spiked off his stick early on the defense by Aaron Bessie. Covered behind the goal by Santelli with a left wing lead feed at his own line. McGinnis in the middle at center for Ryan Alves. Alves from center circle drift went in behind the Danville goal to our right. Dashers controlling their way at center zone. Gullo on left wing at the line. The shot that was picked this side by Mullen. Rebound into the offensive right wing corner. They jostle for it vigorously there, trying to ferret it free. With Susie, he was upended by Zylock. They tangled truculently deep in that Battle Creek left wing corner. Ferreted free massively by Marcus. He's away on left wing at center for Xander across the Danville line. That's Xander's shot. That was right on, and White will glove that one and hold at the right edge of his goal crease to our right. No further play. We have played 8 seconds shy of 6 minutes. First pre-game scoreless early shots on goal. Rumblebees 3, Danville 2. From the faceoff, half a Danville line contained on the right point by Gino Mendy. He tried to thunder into the circle with a centering pass. That one was halted by Enzor, who chased in the corner by Xander. He escaped the clutches of Xander, and he's away. Enzor through center, wheels across on right wing over the Battle Creek line from the side of the goal. Entering it, top of the right side for Zylak, the shot, that's right on, and Mullen stepped out, sealed the angle, and nestles it in his chest. No further play. Danville will coerce a faceoff deep in Battle Creek territory. Circle left of Jake Mullen and the Rumblebees goal. From the draw at the top of the slot, the Brosnan shot didn't make it through. Blocked in front by Nicoletti. Deflects to the blue line on the right side of Munson. Will just sail it into Danville territory. Danville controls it its own line on left wing. Prepared to Hain will direct it in behind the Battle Creek goal. Controlled by Nicoletti. It is moving from Munson. Now Munson muscles his way through center at the Danville line. Shooting right on stick to side by White. Covered behind the goal by Bobby Killian. Pass hauled by Nicoletti. A pinch to point. Barging him to the left wing corner with a centering pass. The Nicoletti centering pass glanced off the side of the net. Controlled by Danville. They'll control up their own line. Killian on the right defense. Crunch by Carey as he sent that puck wiggling like a reptile. All the way into the Battle Creek right wing corner where Nicoletti lost control. It was stolen in the corner by Hildebrand, centering to the crease. And Hain was robbed point blank range by a gilded club save by Mullen at the left edge of the crease in electrifying fashion. No further play. Faceoff on Encore left of the Battle Creek netminder from the faceoff on the right. Point Zylak fired the shot. He blazed it wide. Rebound of the Battle Creek left wing corner for Champlain in the middle at center now. For Battle Creek's Aaron Bessieu gains the Danville line. He tried to dish it to the right wing half ball for Alves. Halted by Nayer. Nayer at center over the Battle Creek line. Now for Barack off with a spinorama shot. Mullen the save. Rebound into the offensive left wing corner. Controlled there by Barakoff. Stripped naked on the defense by Siegel. And Battle Creek breaks out. Now Ryan Alves finds his way through center on right wing and floats it behind the goal as both teams change. Game scoreless as we reach the 8-minute mark of the opening period. The shots on goal are balanced. Hip for a side. But Danville is away on right wing. Nick Pellowitz center was stripped from behind by Margetz. It was tailgating on his bumper. Margetz from center's circle will steer it back into the Danville zone. On the right defense, Killian circle on the left side for Murray in the middle. That's center for Zylak gaining the Battle Creek line. Converged down by both Susi and Mini on the defense, and it's Chino Mini to control in his own zone. Circle to circle on the left defense for Susi. Susi holds. Susi up to the board. That's center and upper carry over the line. The centering pass right to the doorstep for Natty. Was wrapped up there by Gallo. Back comes Danville on left wing. It's Ain hurrying through center, gaining the Battle Creek line. Stripped naked on the defense, though, by Siegel, who leads on left wing at center for Munson. Over the line now, returning it now to Rick Siegel at the top of the left circle. Angling to the offensive right wing corner there for McElroy. Scotty was occupied there by Ain, but controlled on the offensive left forward by a Battle Creek. Carl Munson, he was upended there by Hildebrand, who overpowered him as he steers it into Battle Creek territory. We're still scoreless. Rick Siegel on right wing will lug at the center. Send it in behind the Danville goal for the Rumble Beast. Covering in the left wing corner on the camera is Jesse Brawson. Now Brawson leads in the middle at center. Hildebrand, he was leaned down by McGinnis. Covered behind the Battle Creek. Cold to our left by Nicoletti. Throw it around the boards, contained on the right point by the suddenly materializing Seth Enzer. Now Enzer slipped it in behind the goal. He tried to set it up there for Hildebrand. Strip taken by Nicoletti. Nicoletti on the Rumble Bees defense will direct at the center zone where McGinnis really cracked Barakoff as he drove it in behind the goal. Recapturing in Nicoletti, sending John Champlain screaming through center over the line on right wing for Alves. The shot, that's right on. And White caught that one up the left post, genuflecting to his left pad to secure it. No further play. 3 seconds shy, 3 seconds shy of the midway point. First period, game scoreless and penalty-less. The penalties, the shots on goal, they're also even at four aside. On the face of Betsy on right point, the screenshot, White the save, the rebound right in front. Sander fired the shot, and he rang it off the post. On the right up White. Back comes Danville. They escape a close call in from center zone to Soriario. Well, just backhand it to the crease where it's covered by Mullen. No further play. 90-second break. 9:48 left. First period was scoreless. This is Rumble Beast Hockey on 102.7 FM. The Fat One.
Allegra Marketing Print Mail is a full-service marketing print mail communications company based right here in Battle Creek. We help companies solve simple or complex problems through our expertise, creative solutions, and can-do attitude. Allegra Marketing Print Mail provides marketing, consulting, graphic design, and sales promotion products for small and medium-sized businesses, nonprofits, and institutions. Let us get to know your business. Contact us today at 269-968-2403 or at allegramarketingprint.com.
At Jimmy John's, Freaky Fast makes it freaky fresh. Jimmy John's in Battle Creek makes Freaky Fast sandwich. Using only the freshest ingredients. Quality is their way of life. That's what they spend 6 hours slicing all their natural meats and fresh vegetables and baking their fresh bread in-house every day. If you need delivery, your Battle Creek Jimmy John's has you covered. They also offer last-minute catering for any occasion. Stop by or order online at jimmyjohns.com. Jimmy John's with two locations, 5568 Beckley Road in downtown, 25 Capitol Avenue Southwest.
Jack Pearl's Team Sports is still the one great location for all the sporting equipment you need. Jack Pearl's has been here for a very long time, and they continue to serve our community with great friendly service. And they're always great prices. At Jack Pearl's, they customize products to show your team spirit. It's always the place to go to for all your team and sports apparel. Sporting goods, commercial printing, t-shirts, screen printing, clothing accessories, you name it. Jack Pearl's got it. Jack Pearl's Team Sports, always giving to our community. 26 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. JackPearlsTeamSports.com.
Jerry Ficarelli rejoining you live from Battle Creek. Midway through the opening period, where scoreless. Face for Brian Mullen, Rumblebee's goal. From the draw behind the goal is Bessie around the board and left wing of his own line for Xander. Give it a rough drive by Palmerville, who crunched and pinching the point, but it's controlled at the Danville line there by Troy Murray, who directs it to Battle Creek territory. On the defense, Siegel brushed the backhand back to the Danville line. They'll control from there as Enzo returned to the Battle Creek zone. Oh, as Bessie turns it over right in front to Gullo with a shot. Oh, right on Mullen. Makes the save, and he'll bounce on top of that one at the top of the crease after Aaron Bessie committed a flagrant turnover between the hash marks and circles right smack dab dead in front of his goalkeeper, Mullen, who rescued his mates from dire straits with that supreme save. Now from the faceoff deep in the Battle Creek right wing corner, Minnie sets it up there for McElroy. Scotty drove it to center. At center, Palmerville will gain the line on right wing and backhand it to the Battle Creek right corner. Minnie is there. Minnie couldn't control that. It's stolen on the right point. Bobby Killian screenshot to black to behind the goal by Susie. Duck out there by Danville. Hildebrand behind the goal is giving a rough ride there on the defense by Minnie, who muscled him mightily. They jostle Port vigorously behind the goal. Bronson was rudely upended to the back of the net there by McElroy. Scott, controlled again by Danville from the right circle. Hildebrand angled it to the Battle Creek right wing corner. Retrieved there by Munson. He hoists it to center. At center, Palmerville wrapped it up the board to the front of the Battle Creek goal. Susie to cover on the defense. And Susie will direct it to the Danville line. Still scoreless with 8-12 left first period. Danville at its own line and they're away from center circle. Levi Armstrong swept it in behind the goal. Tracked down there by Minnie, colliding there with Nayer. Nayer overpowered by Minnie, who dragged out into the ice, but it's contained on right point by Zylak. Zylak right in front for Barakov with a shot. He scores. Barakov, who had a cold air last night, Artem Barakov connects. time of the goal, 7:53, and it's 1-0 Danville. The Rumblebees' inability to clear the zone cost them an expensive price as Danville, for a second consecutive night, produces the game's first goal, this one at 12:07. And it's a 1-0 Dashers lead. Back up and a goal here last night as well in Danville, 7-1, rubbing of Battle Creek. Now from the face of Mar gets over the line on the left side. Rosander right in front of Burnett. It was uncovered and he fanned on the shot. He was cruising at the right edge of the door's test perch. Puck to the left wing board for Nathan Margetts toward the corner. Burnett, mission aborted there on the defense. Controlled by Nayer as he gains the Battle Creek line, but offside of the left wing for the Dashers was this goal scorer, Barakoff. No further play. Barakoff on the goal from Nayer and to Soriero at 12:07. And it's a 1-0 Danville lead. From the face, Munson through center, barrels in over the Danville line from the top of the left circle. He fired the shot, he ripped it over top of the net. Puck behind the Danville goal to our right, covered there by Killian. And Bobby Killian will sweep it the length of the ice. Icing the call against Danville. Again, it was Artem Efimov, Barakoff on the goal, his second of the season and in this series. The assist to Jesse Nayer and A.J. Tesserario at 12:07. From the face of on the right point, it's contained there by Aaron Bessie. Drove it in behind the goal. Covering on the right board, the Hildebrand poke check by Carey. On the left point for Santelli, the shot was weak. Blocked by Hildebrand, he sent Haney stepping it through center over the side on the crisscross to a poor bad offensive mission for Battle Creek. Puck to the Danville blue line, and from there, Zylako backhand to center. On it, Minnie. Minnie on right wing. Hits the Danville line, shooting right on. White the Saville turtle on top of that one with 6'4", 287-pound Lee J. McGinnis intimidating as he was casting his giant-sized shadow into the Harley White goal crease. Beast force a face-off deep in the Danville zone. It's a 1-0 Dashers lead. Late puck now controlled at center on left wing by McGinnis. He was shouldered by Armstrong, which dragged out of the ice. By McGinnis, there's the puck. Kerem's in behind the Rumblebees goal. Mullen stepped out in congestion, sets it up at the back wall for Minnie around the right board for Alves. Checked by Murray, who pinched the point. They dangled fragilely midway inside the Battle Creek line along their right boards. Retrieved by Minnie, cross ice and left wing at his own line for Lee J. McGinnis. Up the boards, that's that over John Champlain. He drove it behind the goal. It's a 1-0 Danville lead, 5:31 left in period one. Dashers away at center. Murray on right wing was tripped by Knapp. There'll be a penalty coming up to the Rumblebees and Karn deep Knapp. The first penalty of the game. This one for tripping the time, 14:38. Knapp, 2 minutes for tripping at 14:38. This will create Danville's first power play in the game's first power play of the night. And the Dashers' power play last night was venomous. It was 5-for-9. Five power play goals from the faceoff. Palmer to left point, right point for Boros. And the shot right on. Kicked up by Mullen. Rebound to the beam behind the goal. Hildebrand dug it out. Sets it up right corner for Hayne, who had a goal and an assist last night. Margetts and Margetts for the Rumblebees with a right-hand smash, go right below the length of the ice. Controlled by Danville. Now Brawson through center with a Rumblebee line on left wing with a shot. Nicoletti deflected it behind the goal. The Kieran to the right corner. Scampering to it is Nicoletti along the right board. They'll deliver it for Carey. And Carey, the former four-year-old Prowler, will back into the Danville line. Control by Hain. Hain through center. Hain at the Battle Creek line from the top of the left circle. Fired the shot and on the defense. Rumblebee's Chino Mini deflects it over the glass into the crowd behind the Battle Creek goal to our left. No further play. 1:14 for the Nant, tripping Paddley. And 4:35 for the opening period, 1-0 Daniel. From the faceoff, won by McElroy Scott. And from behind the Battle Creek goal to our left, it's Chino Mini to wire it the length of the ice. Danville is away at center. Jesse Nair in full play. Tears in over the Rumblebee line. Sets to the corner for Tesoriero. He bolts in front. Crash to the crease. The shot. Well, in the save. Rebound to the right point for Zylak. Zylak now maneuvers it to the top of the circle. Step the shot. He blazed it wide with Nair flashing the crease. Puck left point for Murray. Right point now for Ensor with a shot. And he blazed it wide. Puck to the offensive corner for Barakoff. Pulled in there by McElroy Scott. He's away from center. McElroy Scott will launch one behind the goal with 22 seconds with a power play. 3:43 for the first period. 1-0 Danville, and they control on their man advantage. That's center Zylak, who had a pair of power play goals last night, was skated off by Siegel, who backs it up inside his own line. Scaled it off the glass for Leaper. Champlain at center, spinning in over the Danville line and offside on right wing. More Battle Creek with Shea Carey and the Rumble Bees for on the 2-on-1. Fast jailbreak on a short-handed situation. Carey suffering a degree of high anxiety was offside by his pride. Poor Battle Creek. Still 5 seconds remaining in the net. Bentley, it's a 1-0 Danville lead. On the face of the Danville blue line, Killian on the right defense will step out to center and fling it in on goal. Mullen directs him to the right wing corner where Siegel occupied the Danville player. Nicolo covered left side of the goal for Nicoletti. He lost control of the puck as it bounces to the crease. And Mullen will turtle on top of that one with Patrick Stylak and Nicolo. Both having him surrounded at the doorstep with their bayonets drawn dangerously and dynamically. No further play. That'll produce a face-off circle left and Mullen, but it's a major breakthrough for Battle Creek. They withstood Danville's first man advantage of the game. From the faceoff, Zander on left wing. Stepped out to center, back into the offensive left wing corner where Nat was overtaken there by Killian. Killian goes cross ice on left wing at center Bomberville. He'll angle it to the Battle Creek left wing corner. Susie is there. Susie now will bank it off the boards to center on Battle Creek's left side. Backing it up at his own line on the left defense is Palmerville in the middle. It's center for Hildebrand. He chitterbugs his way over the Battle Creek line with a centering pass right through the crease. Controlled by Battle Creek. Susie at his own line. Lost control right in front of the net. No near shot. Robbed by Mullen. Point blank range as that time Jesse Nair after the Battle Creek turned over in front of their own goal. And Nair was right at the crease, and he was stifled and stymied by this stupendo of Mullen with an acrobatic save, point blank range. Still 1-0 Danville, 2:20 left, first period. From the faceoff dugout, right wing board now by Barakoff, center point straight away now for Nair. Nair to the left wing board for Murray, centering to the crease, and Mullen will vacuum that with the big web of that left catching glove. No further play. Danville beginning to dominate as they did last night. They've outshot Battle Creek 13-7 in the first period and 9-3 in the second half of this period. They lead 1-0 from the faceoff puck to the Rumblebees right wing corner. They jostle board vigorously there. Paired is braved by Munson, the Swedish inboard. He'll angle opposite corner left side for Nicoletti. He'll backhand the line, contained on the right point. Enzor fired the shot, and he ripped it wide. Puck to the Battle Creek right corner on it. There's Siegel. He's sailed to the line. Knocked down by Murray. Pinching the point. He steps around Siegel into the offensive left wing circle. Dishes off left wing corner. Controlled there now by Nayer. Back left point. Volleys it to Murray. The shot. That's right on. And Mullen with an unobstructed, unobscured view was on the scene to glove it. No further play. Late first period, 1:29 remaining. It's a 1-0 Danville lead. Face turn right on Mullen, B's goal. From the face, saw control by Battle Creek. Alvis springs out of the back on right wing from center. He directs right to the net, minder up. Harley White returns at the Battle Creek territory. In front of the Battle Creek goal, it's Aaron Bessie to collect it. On left wing, it's center by McGinnis with a depth touch. He'll just direct it in to Danville territory. Dashers will control it their own line. Alex Palmerville on the defense. Steps out to center on left wing. The minute for the period up. Boards for Gullo. Gullo gains the Battle Creek line. Crunched along the boards, clamorously by Champlain, who dumped him, but contained on the right point opposite side by Killian. Shooting! That was wide of the short side as Zylak was dumped at the doorstep by Champlain. Puck to the blue line again for Killian one more time with a rising shot. This time the Bobby Killian shot took off and plied and disappears over the glass into the crowd behind that, that Paddle Creek call to our left. No further play. Last minute of the period, 36 seconds to be exact, and it's 1-0 Danville. On the face of the Battle Creek line, last sowed by Susie. At left wing at center, Malcolm Zender, the Swedish rookie, things up behind the goal. White steps out. He hides it away from the intrusion of Carndap deep, throwed into the Battle Creek zone, controlled by Brawson. Cross and thunders with the left circle with a shot. Oh, he was checked from behind by Nat. Now Carney Knapp springs through center, crossing the line with a shot. That was knocked down between the edge marks and circles in front of the goal by Palmerville. A romp through center on White Wing. Over the Battle Creek line, but the horn sounds, ending the opening period as Danville gains the lead in the latter stages as Barakoff scores from Nayer and A.J. To Soriero at 12:07. Shots on goal in the first period. Danville 13. And Battle Creek 7. The Rumblebees have now been outshot in all four periods of this series. Danville 0-1 on the power play, 5-10 on the series. The Rumblebees were bereft of such luxury. One period of play complete. Hockey night in Battle Creek. It's Saturday night's pro. The second and concluding installment of this two-game homestand series to approach Battle Creek Pro Hockey history in the FPHL Rumblebee style as Battle Creek seeks to salvage a split in this two-game coming out party. One period of play complete. It's Danville 1, the Rumblebees 0. We're on a three-minute break. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
WFAT, Battle Creek. W274AQ, Battle Creek. AM 930 and 102.7, the Fat One.
Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza. Happy's Pizza is not your typical pizza place. Our dough is fresh, never frozen. Our pizza sauce is always homemade. Our veggies are hand-cut, fresh, and delicious. Your pizza is cooked to order just for you, and we deliver more than our great pizza. From ribs to chicken to seafood, Happy's offers delicious food made to order. Free delivery on all catering orders. 1180 Columbia Avenue West. Order online at happyspizza.com. Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza.
Battle Creek Family Chiropractic is the official chiropractor of our pro hockey team, the Rumble Bees. At Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, they take great pride in providing the finest chiropractic wellness care to their patients. It provides spinal correction utilizing gentle chiropractic techniques and corrective exercises where they teach their patients special exercises to help strengthen and correct their own unique problem. There's lifestyle advice, nutritional counseling, massage therapy, and spinal and postural screenings. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, 32 West Van Buren Street, the official chiropractor of the Rumble Bees. The Rumble Bees are proud to highly recommend one of the premier restaurants in Battle Creek. Welcome to Kitchen Proper, 34 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. Kitchen Proper features scratch-made food with a primary focus on local products. Innovation meets comfort food is their motto. Kitchen Proper offers a warm, inviting space with an open kitchen so their guests can watch the chefs in action. Items are made to order. Try their house favorites like fresh pastas with decadent sauces, fresh fish, hand-cut steaks, creamy risottos, and fresh, unique salads. Kitchen Proper, downtown. Five-star, all the way.
Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher are attorneys at law. They've been proudly serving the greater Battle Creek community for over 75 years. They specialize in estate planning, probate and trust administration, corporate and business law, family law, and bankruptcy. If you need help, call us today at 269-965-7000. Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher, attorneys at law, serving the community for over 75 years and proud supporters of our pro hockey team, the Battle Creek Rumblebees.
The Griffin Grill and Pub is a classic tavern offering Irish American plates and many beers, plus live music. Located at 38 Michigan Avenue West, Griffin Grill and Pub serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Every day they strive to offer a great food and drink experience that sets them apart as being comfortable, fun, and original. Offering 36 draft beers from around the world, Griffin Grill and Pub is the only pub in Battle Creek with two cask condition hand-pulled ales. They also have the reputation for the best fish and chips in town. 14 TVs, 5 dart lanes, and just a great atmosphere. Griffin Grill and Pub, downtown Battle Creek.
Supercuts is the chosen hair salon of your Battle Creek Rumblebees. With a variety of services, from consistent quality haircuts for men and women to a relaxing tea tree experience to color services at an affordable price, their hairstylists are some of the best trained in the business. Specializing in haircuts for men, you get in and out while still receiving excellent service, including a hot towel at the end of every haircut. They'll listen to you and will recommend a style and products that will help you look and feel good. No appointment necessary and open 7 days a week. Check in online. Supercuts, the chosen hair salon of your Rumblebees.
Terry Ficarelli rejoining you live from the rink, Battle Creek. One period of play complete. Our first intermission. Danville 1, the Rumblebees nothing. 24 hours ago after the initial stanza, Danville on the impetus of power play strikes early and late in the opening frame had vaulted into a 2-0 lead and Roop to a 7-1 domination and demolition of Battle Creek, ruining the Rumblebees' grand opening night extravaganza bonanza. A vastly inspired, certainly a more cohesive and certainly a more harmonious Rumblebees team we saw in the opening period tonight. They played with more rhythm, more continuity in the opening period. However, Danville did strike just 2 minutes past the midway portion as they exploited a Battle Creek turnover between the hash marks and circles, right smack dab dead in front of goalkeeper Jake Mullen, and capitalized expertly to register their eighth goal in the series, while the Rumblebees have riposted a scant once. One period of play complete. It's Danville 1, the Rumblebees nothing. The game refereed by Chris Hoy and Adam Fish. the linesman, Nick Sharip and Barry Meeb. We want to remind you that the Rumble Bees continue this season opening five-game homestand next weekend with a pair of outings on Friday and Saturday nights at 7:35. They'll play host to the Mentor Icebreakers of Ohio. It'll be the Rumble Bees and Mentor next Friday and Saturday night at 7:35 right here at the rink, Battle Creek. Rumble Bees season tickets, single game tickets are on sale now at the Rumble Bees offices located right here in the rink, Battle Creek, or check us out online at BHockey, that's B-E-E, BHockey.com, or any of the available social platforms at BC Rumble Bees, or give the Rumble Bees a call at 269-243-5027, 269-243-5027. Catch the buzz, Battle Creek. Let's buzz with the Rumble Bees. One period of play complete. Danville 1 and Battle Creek nothing. Opening period was scoreless until 12:07. Back from Rumble Bees at times dominated for the first time in the series. But Battle Creek defensively in their own zone to our left was guilty of a turnover between the hash marks and circles right in front of goalkeeper Jake Mullen. And Danville, with its high-tech, high-voltage attack, capitalized as it was Artem Efimov Parakov who converted up the doorstep. His second goal of the season and of this series. Parakov from Jesse Nair and A.J. Tesserario at the time of the goal, 12:07. And that has staked Danville to its present tense 1-0 lead. They outshot the Rumble Bees in the first period 14-7. And through the second half of the opening period, they outshot Battle Creek 10-3. Only one penalty in the period, that to Battle Creek's Carndeep Net. He was tagged with a 2-minute minor, a tripping transgression, a 15-16. But unlike last night, when the Rumble Bees penalty killing units succumbed to the tune of five, count them, five Danville power play strikes, the Rumble Bees penalty killing unit was operating at full optimum efficiency as they precluded the power play smolderings of that Danville team in that opening period. Their power play 0-1, while Battle Creek was bereft of such luxury. Four more games across the circuit tonight as all 10 teams in the league resume action on this, the second night of the 10th anniversary season of the FPHL. In the meantime, tonight, it's Saturday Night Hockey here in Battle Creek, Saturday Nitro. We're in our first intermission. We're live from the rink, Battle Creek. Danville won the Rumble Bees nothing. We're on a 2-minute break. This is Rumble Bees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill continues to be the number one destination in the Battle Creek area for juicy steaks and those delicious mouth-watering burgers. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill features those hard-to-find selections of whiskeys and bourbons. It's a comfort food restaurant with a great whiskey bar and great party entertainment. Every Friday and Saturday nights, there are two live bands beginning at 5 p.m. Car night on Fridays, bike night on Saturdays. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, 3965 West Dickman Road. Graphics to Go is here to help organize all of your promotional needs. We promise to deliver better ideas, better timing, better budgets through our exceptional staff of industry professionals. We provide promotional products and services that go above and beyond, making you and your business a major success. Graphics to Go can promise solutions before problems. They have merchandise apparel, mugs, glasses, office and desk accessories, and top tech equipment. At Graphics to Go, staying comfortable and complacent is simply not an option. Contact them at graphicstogoinc.com.
At Fox's Pizza Den in Battle Creek, they make the freshest, most delicious pizza, specialty hoagies, and mouthwatering scrumptious sides every day for their customers. They serve the absolute very best pizzas, strombolis, nearly world-famous wedgies, and gourmet pizzas. All of their meals are made with the finest ingredients and then baked to perfection. Always fast and friendly service. Fox's Pizza Den, Battle Creek. Order online for delivery or pick up at Fox's Pizza Den, BattleCreek.com. 269-979-9869. Did you have the first Fleetwood Mac Rumors album? I wore out my first one. Fleetwood Mac, one of the best-selling bands of all time. We couldn't get enough. They took 50 years of music and made their Don't Stop collection. They're making a final stop of Fleetwood Mac's world tour in Vegas, too. You can catch them November 16th and all weekend long. 1027 The Fat One is showcasing Fleetwood Mac. It's magnificent.
Ring Battle Creek, our first intermission. For Danville 1, the Rumblebees, nothing. For the Rumblebees, not in uniform tonight. Left wing Cliff Ogle serving a one-game suspension, while rookie center Eli Kinsman has been deactivated. Tonight, for the Rumblebees, is Kyle Quick. Danville, meanwhile, is operating with its same lineup as last night, when they dismantled the Rumblebees by the result of 7-1 in a rather resounding pounding. In the meantime, this Rumblebees programming note, you can stay up to date every day, even when there's not a game. It's the Rumblebees Hockey Update, Monday through Friday, afternoon primetime drive time at 4:35 right here on your exclusive radio flagship home for Rumblebees FPHL Pro Hockey Action, 1027 FM, the Bat 1, and 9:30 a.m. And don't forget, you can catch us on the live stream. The live stream at 1027WFAT.com, 1027WFAT.com. Click the Listen Now button and you'll be tuned up and tuned in for all the action this season of Battle Creek Rumblebees Pro Hockey. We are live from the rink, Battle Creek. This is our first intermission, Saturday Night Hockey. It's Danville 1, Rumblebees nothing. We'll be back. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 1027 FM, the Bat 1.
It's the best lunch place in town and right in the heart of downtown Battle Creek. The Barista Blues Cafe, 91 Michigan Avenue West, features a fantastic menu of American and Italian cuisine. This place is a diamond in the rough. Barista Blues Cafe is a great place to grab a quick bite or a quick lunch, and they always have great daily lunch specials. Enjoy a hot cup of coffee, great conversation, and a friendly smile. Locally owned and operated, Barista Blues Cafe is always focused on customer satisfaction. Barista Blues Cafe, come on in and join the fun.
The Rumblebees want you to stop by the Cricket Club, Battle Creek's premier bar. The Cricket Club features over 50 beers on tap on the longest wooden bar in the state of Michigan at over 90 feet long. The Cricket Club is especially well known for their handcrafted cocktails, as well as their specialty pizzas, other food items, and the broadest selection of spirits in town. The Cricket Club is conveniently located at 36 West Michigan Avenue downtown. The Cricket Club is the high for the Rumblebees.
Terry Ficarelli rejoining you live from Rink Battle Creek. Our first intermission, Danville 1, Rumblebees nothing. Let's update you on what is happening in the FPHL. Four more games across the circuit tonight, and they're all the second and concluding games of four-game series, of two-game series on the same four fronts of Friday night. Port Huron will be at Danbury. Columbus will be in Delaware. Carolina in Elmira. A watered down host cement or last night on opening night. And certainly a rare accomplishment. The road teams prevailed in all five games across the circuit last night. Here, of course, in Battle Creek, the Rumblebees were roasted by Danbury 7-1. That should say Danville 7-1 in Elmira in Commissioner's Cup revisited from last season. Carolina again stunned the Danforces 2-0 after they captured the Commissioner's Cup at the expense of Elmira last season. In game one last night in the New York Hamlet, it was Carolina 2, Elmira 0. In Delaware last night, the debuting Thunder were subdued by Columbus 5-2. In Danbury, the Hat-Tricks were defeated in overtime by Port Huron 5-4. And in Watertown, the Wolves were waylaid by Mentor 3-1. That brings you right up to date on our FPHL scoreboard tonight from Rink, Battle Creek. Rumblebees continue this season, opening five-game homestand next weekend, next Friday and Saturday nights. He'll want to be here 7:35 face-off both nights. Rumblebees lock antlers, lock horns with the Mentor icebreakers. Meanwhile, second period action is moments away from the Rink, Battle Creek tonight. Last night, Battle Creek scored its only goal of the season on a Vinny Susi power play goal at 14:29 after the Danville club had raced into a 4-0 lead with a pair of second period goals, duplicating their first period output. Second period action moment. Away, it's Danville 1, the Rumblebees 0. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat 1.
Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza. Happy's Pizza is not your typical pizza place. Our dough is fresh, never frozen. Our pizza sauce is always homemade. Our veggies are hand-cut, fresh, and delicious. Your pizza is cooked to order just for you, and we deliver more than our great pizza. From ribs to chicken to seafood, Happy's offers delicious food made to order. Free delivery on all catering orders. 1180 Columbia Avenue West. Order online at happyspizza.com. Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza.
Allegra Marketing Print Mail is a full-service marketing print mail communications company based right here in Battle Creek. We help companies solve simple or complex problems through our expertise, creative solutions, and can-do attitude. Allegra Marketing Print Mail provides marketing, consulting, graphic design and sales promotion products for small and medium-sized businesses, nonprofits, and institutions. Let us get to know your business. Contact us today at 269-968-2403 or at AllegraMarketingPrint.com.
Halt up for second period. Action. Danville 1, Rumblebees 0. Harley right in goal to our left for Danville. Jake Mullen in goal to our right for the Rumblebees. You look into your radios on 102.7, the Bat 1. From the faceoff at the Rumblebee line on the left wing board. Mini on the defense. Now will direct at the center. Control by Danville at the center. Tripe on left wing. It's up to the defense, but on that side, Palmerville, he over to the side of the goal and lying on his right side with his pad stack. Goalkeeper Jake Mullen will freeze the frozen rubber. No further play, but early in this second period, Danville forces a face-off deep in Battle Creek territory, circle left of goalkeeper Jake Mullen. I think we're getting a change on the shots on goal in the first period, too. Good grief. Face of the curl left a mullet. In the Battle of Creek Hole, we now have Danbo at 19 shots in the first period, and Battle of Creek with 11. So your guess is as good as mine. So they weren't even close. Here's apparently the net. The goal behind Mullen needs repair. And linesman Nick Sharippa will perform the overtime duties. Faceoff left to the goal. Kane won at top of the circle. Crossing with a shot. He ripped it over top of the net. Rebound beyond the goal. Kane digs it out, centering and knocked out of the crease alertly on the defense. There by Bessie. Pucked into the right wing corner for Kane. Kane centering it. Bounces in front of the goal. Covered there by Nath. There's going to be a Danville penalty coming up. In the Battle Creek right circle, the Rumble Beast player Nathan Margetts was unceremoniously dumped. High playing assistant coach and leading scorer Justin Prossen, and he'll be tagged with the 2 minute mark. We'll await the official call. The time is 49 seconds. Boy, the second penalty of the game, both Miners, the first to Danville. The Rumble Beast power play last night was 1-for-7, accounting for their only goal thus far in this early season. Faceoff right of White in the Danville goal. We'll await the call on the penalty. I believe it's Prossen, 2 minutes for tripping. And the time is 49 seconds. From the faceoff, puck to the offensive left corner, chased down by Margetts. He was checked here by Haynes. Rides to center left wing, accelerates over the Battle Creek line, centering it between the edge mark and circles. Right in front for Hildebrand with a backhand shot. He scores! Tanner Hildebrand, short-handed goal. And the Danville lead grows to 2-0. And for Hildebrand, who had a power play goal and an assist last night, he engineers his second goal of this early season and in this series. This one short-handed at 1-10. The Battle Creek power play boomerangs. Hildebrand on a single assist from Hain at 1-10. It's 2-0 Danville. The Rumble Bees will maintain power play time. Nicoletti behind the goal. Sets it up left side of the goal. Now for Munson in the middle. That's center now for Quick, who speeds in over the Danville line. Dishing to the right wing board for McElroy. Scott's pulled on by Gallo. Breaking away at center. Nicoletti with a flying going right in on. Cole with a shot, Mullen the save. Pacino Mini, the victimized defenseman on the breakaway by Gallo. Slashed the speedy left wing from Danville, and Mini will be banished with a 2 minute minor for slashing. That will eliminate the power play after only 53 seconds. The time of the Mini penalty for slashing 1:43. Both teams will skate a man short. It was Hildebrand on the goal from Haynes, short-handed at 1-10. Both teams a man short in a 2-0 Danville lead. Now it's Jesse Neer over the Battle Creek Flyer from the offensive right circle. The centering pass was blocked by Champlain. He'll head man at his own line for the pirouetting Ryan Alves. Centery barrels in over that Battle Creek line. Drove it in behind the goal as he was leaned down on the defense by Aaron Bessie. They tangled, truckling along the boards, controlled there by Nett. Nett for Rumblebees in front of the goal for Bessie on left wing at center for Nett. Nett was slammed down by Anserl on the boards, but retrieved on retreat in Rumblebees territory by Nicoletti on left wing at center for an upright. Carn deep Nett, who gains the
Danville line. He was crunched, clamors along the boards again by Ensign from the Danville up boards. It's Croy Murray to send it into the Battle Creek zone. Scraped up the back wall by Vinny Suitsi with a lead at center. Xander. Xander explodes over the Danville line, swerving to the right circle. The top of the circle for Phoenix. McElroy's got that mission aborted there by Hayne. Hayne throw it to the Battle Creek line where it's reached free by Xander. Left it on the left fourth for Santelli. And Frank Santelli on the Battle Creek defense will just sail it in behind the goal. In 8 seconds, the penalty to Minnie will expire. Danville on a partial power play and they lead 2-0. Now Killian circle to circle in his own zone. The left event for Palmerville leading crisply in the middle of center for Hayne. He darts it over the line right in front for Hildebrand with a shot. Mullen the save, point blank range. And the Battle Creek goaltender deflects that over the glass and into the crowd. No further play. The penalty box is now flashing the vacancy signs as the penalties to our Brossman and Mini expire, but Danville inflicted damage in the form of that Hildebrand short and a goal to widen their lead to 2-0. Now Patrick Zielak behind the Rumblebees pull, centering it right through the crease. Puck to the Battle Creek left wing corner. They will muscle for it mightily there. Zielak was dumped on the defense by Nicoletti, but contained left point by Murray. Shouldered by Munson. He'll control with a cross-eyed pass on left wing at center of Shea Carey. He tried to spring in behind the defense at the Danville line, but he was skated off by Murray. Dug out behind the goal by Knapp. Net to the side of the goal. Sandry comes back center point for Bessie. Right point for Nicoletti. He'll ring it around the back while the left corner for Knapp. That was aborted on the defense by Ensor. Drove it deep into the Battle Creek zone. Control by Battle Creek. Zielak fire the shot. That's right on. Well, in the sake, puck control between the rings in front of his own goal by Battle Creek. Siegel on left wing at center for Nando, crosses the Danville line with a shot right on. And Harley White in a rather quick silver agility fashion kicks it over the glass into the crowd. No further play. 14:57 remaining, second period. And it's a 2-0 Danville lead on the short and a goal from Hildebrand. From the faceoff, top of the left circle, now the screenshot. And Barakoff was in the way of that one. And he deflects it over the glass into the crowd. Faceoff and encore right of Harley White is blank to battle. From the draw, out. Aldis reaches into the dot in the circle of Barrett at three behind the goal for McGinnis. Right through his wickets and cover along the boards on the left side by Danville. Killian behind the goal. Around the boards on the left wing now for Nahur. That was halted by Battle Creek. Said John Champlain. He'll curl back to center on retreat. Now Champlain over the Danville line for Ryan Alkins. Alvis now left to topless clapper Champlain. He'll swerve to the right boards where he was cracked lustily by Jesse Nayer right in front of the Battle Creek bench. Nayer will power the puck to the Battle Creek line before he's muscled on the boards by Siegel in front of the bench, right in front of the Danville bench. Meanwhile, Danville soldiers on in behind the Battle Creek goal where Barakoff will send it to the left edge of the crease and the nim minor mullet. Crawled in a spread eagle fashion, will paw that puck with an outstretched left glove. No further play. We played exactly 6 minutes in the second period, and it's a 2-0 Danville lead. They've outscored Battle Creek in the series 9-1. Brossen
muscles the puck, powers it to the right corner, working on Siegel, slipped it in behind the goal. The centering fans, Murray screenshot, and he blazed it wide amidst the conga line of legs in front of goalkeeper Mullen. Rebound to the right circle. Oh, Brunson Shire, the shot, he's high and wide. Back comes Battle Creek. Oh, Carl Munson through center, right up barging on left wing. Over the Danville line, he was overtaken on the defense by Ansor, controlled by Danville. At center now, Hildebrand over the Battle Creek line into the right circle. Aim the backhand shot, he whizzed it over top of the net. Whistle sounds, we have an interference penalty coming up. The incident occurring in front of the Battle Creek Cold War right the time, 6:41. And the culprit is Danville's Tanner Hildebrand. Hildebrand, the 2 minute minor for interference in front of the Battle Creek goal. And the time, 6:41. And their first power play of the night, and in this period, Rumblebees saw the power play betray them in the tune of a shorthanded strike stoked by the Foreign Ice Invaders from this Illinois exotic bird. Face on left of White. From the draw, Margaret's one of her Battle Creek, but he's overtaken along the boards there by Bobby Killian, and Killian will aerial it into the Battle Creek bench right at the Danville blue line across the way from us on the Rumblebees second period right wing. No further play. Again, it was Hildebrand, 2 minutes for interference at 6:41. Third minor penalty of the period, the second to Danville. Four minor penalties in the game, and they've been equitably divided two aside. The Danville power play 0 for 2, Rumblebees 0 for 1, and their power play boomeranged in the form of a short and a goal from Danville. Face on the Kerr Circle, left of White, Danville goal. Nathan Margetts in the faceoff for the Bees, opposing Danville's Zylak, who won it. On the right board for Nick Gallo. Gallo comes off the boards and angles the puck the length of the ice. Santelli behind the goal. He will skirt the check as Zylak left it for Karn deep net, who winds it up at his whole line. Now Nat romps through Sand over the Danville line, swerving to the right circle, centering it to the crease, knocked down there by Bobby Killian. Killian wrapped it off the boards into the Battle Creek zone. Bridge free by Santelli on right wing, up the boards at center. Nat crosses the Danville line. The shot did make it through, blocked in front by Killian. Rebound to the top of the slot for McGinnis. Now Lee J. McGinnis fired the shot, and he blazed wide. Rebound the left point for Vincusi. Now Susie loads the gun. The screenshot between the edge mark. Mark then circles and Mark gets redirected. That one just wide. Now McGinnis behind the goal, overpowered. Palmerville to control it on the right board for Karn deep. Nat to the right point for Santel. Dish it back now for Nat. Nat shot high over top of the net. Rebound on the left board. Was on the front porch. Perch at the right edge, and he just directs it home. The time of the power play goal, 8:05. Both of the Bees' goals this season have been scored in the second period of this series, and both on the power play. Based on now Munson's trying to barge in over the Danville line. He tries to drop as from McElroy. Scott, and that one dribbled off the blade of his stick, but contained on the right point by Minnie. Minnie behind the goal for Munson. Munson bites it, but he shoots, he scores! Carl Munson! No goal! No goal! The goal has been nullified. The net is off the Marsh Pegs again. That is costly. Good. Great. If they have the nets actually on Pegs, that would have been a legitimate goal. My, oh my. Was Margetts on the goal? Margetts from Susie and McGinnis. And now we'll check on the time of the goal. Oh, but we have to double check. Check that time. Ball disallowed at the 8:24 mark. Carl Munson from roll up circling. And he really hung court to Cannon, but the net was off the moorings. It's a 2-1 Danville from the face on. How Killian behind the goal. He will shed the check of Shea Carey. Hot left wing at center Tanner Hildebrand at the Battle Creek line, but Brett Ain is offside. No further play. Again, that goal, the power play goal. Margetts first of the season from Susie McGinnis at 8:05. And Vince Susie has been instrumental on both of the Battle Creek goals this year. Both in the second period and both on the power play. He has a goal and an assist. Now from the faceoff, Bumblebees control their own zone on the left side. Shea Carey will cascade the puck into the Danville zone. Duck on the right board by Carl Munson. Munson on the board. Worked it back right point for Manny. Shooting right on. White to Shea Carey. Crowding the crease. Creating a crush. Shea Carey couldn't convert, but dug on right board by Munson. Backs it up to the top of the slot. Munson screenshot would just fly with Carey. Creating havoc at the crease. Puck into the offense. Into the defensive right wing quarter. And from there, Bobby Killian will just send the puck sky dancing over the glass into the crowd. No further play as the Rumblebees are buzzing. They're looking to achieve the equalizer. They have trailed throughout this series. They've never even been deadlocked. And it appeared Munson, it's for the tying goal that was disallowed. It's a 2-1 Danville lead, but the lead is teetering and is somewhat precarious. From the faceoff, controlled in Danville territory. On the defense by Murray, shadowed by the intimidating presence of McGinnis. McGinnis steals left boards for Alves. Alves comes out the boards, going cross-side to the right point for Nicoletti. Kill backhanded into the corner. McGinnis was wrapped up, pulled by Murray, and back comes Danville, and they're away. At center, Barakoff over the Battle Creek line from the left circle. The shot, and Nicoletti on the defense with his spread. Flexed it over the glass into the crowd on that Battle Creek defense. No further play. 10:08 remaining, 8 seconds shy of the midway point, second period. It's a 2-1 Danville lead. In the second period, Danville with 4 shots, game total 23. Bumblebees with 5 shots, came up with a 12. The faceoff in the offing. Circle left of Jake Mullen in the Rumblebees goal. Nick Gullo in the base up, opposing Karn deep net. Now pointed behind the goal for Bessie around the right board for Kyle Quick. Quick now curls back behind the goal, left it for Bessie, right corner board for Santelli. He'll return it to Bessie, throw it off the boards to center circle. Danville will control from there. We're Palmerville aims it behind the Battle Creek goal to our right. Quick in the corner now sets up behind the goal for Santelli. Back for Quick in the corner, anticipated by Gullo, angles it back in the blue line.
Right point for Bobby Killian. Right wing corner number Gullo wrapped up assertively there by the Battle Creek player on that side. Santelli covered in front of the goal there by Aaron Bessie. And Bessie, a missed congestion in front of his own goal, will send that puck shimming all the way to the Danville goal. On the defense, it's Killian to sweep it in behind the Battle Creek goal. Cracked down there by Brawson. Centering pass halted by Santelli, but contained left point by Murray. Murray showers blocked at the top of the circle by Munson. Controlled all low right circle by Hayne. Hayne goes circle to circle for Murray on the left side. The shot that was redirected right through the crease. Whistle sound. Net off the moorings again, this time behind goalkeeper Jake Mullen. No further play. 90-second break. 8:49 left. Second period. It's a close one. Danville 2, the Rumblebees 1. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat 1.
At Jimmy John's, Freaky Fast makes it freaky fresh. Jimmy John's in Battle Creek makes Freaky Fast sandwiches using only the freshest ingredients. Quality is their way of life. That's why they spend 6 hours slicing all their natural meats and fresh vegetables and baking their fresh bread in-house every day. If you need delivery, your Battle Creek Jimmy John's has you covered. They also offer last-minute catering for any occasion. Stop by or order online at jimmyjohns.com. Jimmy John's with two locations, 5568 Beckley Road and downtown, 25 Capitol Avenue Southwest. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic is the official chiropractor of our pro hockey team, the Rumblebees. At Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, they take great pride in providing the finest chiropractic wellness care to their patients. They provide spinal correction utilizing gentle chiropractic techniques and corrective exercises where they teach their patients special exercises to help strengthen and correct their own unique problem. There's lifestyle advice, nutritional counseling, massage therapy, and spinal and postural screenings. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, 32 West Van Buren Street, the official chiropractor of the Rumblebees. The Rumblebees are proud to highly recommend one of the premier restaurants in Battle Creek. Welcome to Kitchen Proper, 34 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. Kitchen Proper features scratch-made food with a primary focus on local products. Innovation meets comfort food is their motto. Kitchen Proper offers a warm, inviting space with an open kitchen so their guests can watch the chefs in action. Items are made to order. Try their house favorites like fresh pastas with decadent sauces, fresh fish, hand-cut steaks, creamy risottos, and fresh, unique salads. Kitchen Proper, downtown. Five-star, all the way.
Back to the play from right point. Enzer shoots, he scores. Seb Enzer on a face-off win for Danville. And Seb Enzer from the right point concealed the shot through a screen and fires his first goal of the season. And that goal really hurts. After the pair, the Rumblebees had tied it on a Carl Munson goal. It's 3-1 Danville. Time of the goal, 11:16. From the base up puck behind the Danville goal to our left and in minor, Arlie White. Around the whiteboards, it is a full amper to Sariero. He drifts it in behind the goal, flagged on and reeled in by Mullen. Mullen behind the goal for Susie for the left corner for the chase of Mullen. Or I should say Mini. Now Mini lost control right in front of the goal. To Neer with a shot. Oh, a scintillating skate save by Mullen. He robbed Jesse Neer. Point blank range and back on Battle of Creek. Net on the move at center. Over the Danville line. Net from the left circle. Fired the shot. That was muffled on the defense there by Baracco. They child support big. Grizzly in the offensive left corner, buried it free by Barakov as he bowled over Susie, but Susie, as he fell, directs it right back behind the Danville goal to our left. Scraped off the back wall by Enzor. Now Enzor's pass stolen in the left wing corner by Lee J. McGinnis. Now McGinnis centering it, net, fire the shot, oh, and he plays it wide. Puck in behind that Danville goal control. Controlled there by Anzor. He'll rim it around the board to center. Controlled by the Rumble Beast from center zone on right wing. Mini charged in with that Danville line, but offside where the Rumble Beast. No further play. He credited the cold at Tanner Hildebrand on the deflection of the Seb Anzor point shot. The time 11-16. Tanner Hildebrand's second goal of the night and his third in this series. Hildebrand has both the Danville strikes stoked in this stanza. From the faceoff in Danville territory on their right wing board, that Luciani behind the goal. He redirects it to the left corner for Palmerville, surrounded there by Alvis and McGinnis. And Alex Palmerville has no recourse but to just send the puck sailing over the glass into the paddle. Creek players bench, no further play. Faceoff circle left of the Danville goal. From the faceoff, McGinnis behind the goal. He slashed Killian and he'll be tagged. Back, he broke the stick of the rookie Danville defenseman. Bobby Killian and Lee J. McGinnis will be tagged with a 2-minute minor for slashing. The time 12:57. So it's 7:03 remaining, second period in a 3-1 lead. The Dashers presented their third power play of the night, their second in the second period. 0-2 tonight. They were 5-9 in a robust fashion last night. From the face of Russell from center point, shoots right on. Patsy Mullen rebound, top of the right circle. Bobby Killian behind the goal for Haney. He'll fan out to the corner. Now Fred Haney back on right point for Palmerville. Now to the left point for Bobby Killian. Killian now trades passes right point for Palmerville. Right corner for Haney. Centering to the crease for Brosnan. Check beautifully by the Munson-Nicoletti combination and David. David Nickel heading from the left side of his own goal, breaks up the length to the ice. Behind the Danville goal to our left, reach free by Killian. Killian on left wing at center now, controlled by Haney, dancing his own over the line, centering it through the crease for Hildebrand. Cracked lust on the defense by Santelli, contained left point by Troy Murray. He was checked there by Marquez, who stepped out to pressure, but contained again. Left point by Brosnan. Center point for Murray with a shot. Blocked at the top of the slot intrepidly by Champlain. Covering though Brosnan. Brosnan pinches right point. Cross ice back. Left point for Murray. Center point straight away for Palmer. Low right side for Brosnan with a shot. And that one sails over the glass into the crowd behind the Battle Creek call to our right. No further play. Still 46 seconds for the McGinnis slashing skullduggery. And 5:48 for the middle period is 3-1 Dashers. Tanner Hildebrand has a pair of second period goals, one of those shorthanded. Rumble Beast goal came on a power play from Nathan Margetz. Now from the faceoff, Danville continuing to pressure in Battle Creek territory on the left point. Murray shot was muffled by McElroy's count, who stepped out. The pressure comes back to Troy Murray beating to the top of the left circle word. Cut to Serio Aero. His shot was blocked by Nicoletti. Deflects to center where Enzo hightailed it over the Rumblebee line. He streaks in behind the goal and rounds the net. Sets it up in the right circle. Barakov centering it. Blocked between the rings and hash marks beautifully by McElroy Scott. And he'll lash up the length of the ice. But still 3 seconds for the man advantage. 3-1 Danville in there away at center zone with a penalty over. Now over the line from the top of the slot. The Barakov shot was kicked out by Mullen. A breakaway for Shea Carey. Carey over the line. He's in alone. He was hooked from behind by the defenseman Palmerville, and he'll be tagged. Shea Carey with that blinding, blazing breakaway speed right down center for the bar. As he outdistanced the somewhat immobile defense of Danville. And Carey, like a human slingshot, flashed him behind the defense. And just as he was set to pull the trigger at the goal crease, he was hooked from behind. To Palmerville, 2 minutes were hooking, and the tie is 15-11. Rumblebees with the power play. They're 1-for-2 tonight. 2-for-9 in the series now. Karandeep Nab outside the rim of the circle at the half wall. Sets it up right corner for Margus. He'll volley it back into the circle for Nat. Now Nat coils. Nat back right corner returns it to Margus. Margus will slip in behind the goal and feed to the blue line left point for Susie. That one was cut off by Niccolo, who anticipated it. Gallo ventures to center and just rainbows the puck back behind the Battle Creek. Coldwire right with a minute 24 for the power play. Now a Battle Creek away. Now Nadat center speeds in over the Danville line. He was overtaken from behind on the defense there by Ensor, but contained. Left point by Santelli. The shot! Right on White the save with Big McGinnis. In front of the goal, screening him from the right side of the goal. Bobby Killian will launch it the length of the ice. We have a delayed penalty coming up, I believe, to Danville as Mullen will speed to the bench with his sixth attacker as the whistle will sound once Killian touches the puck and the Danville goal to our left. And the whistle sounds, and for 49 seconds, the Rumble Beast presented a glorious opportunity here to climb closer. As there is a 2 minute minor coming to Bobby Killian. Killian receives the 2 minute minor. We'll check on the call. The time is 16-22. It was Palmerville for hooking at 15-11. Humblebees with a 2 minute advantage from 49 seconds. They trail 3-1. From the face up deep in the Danville zone, dug on offensive left corner by Shea Carey. He'll dish to the right wing boards. Now center point for McElroy Scott. He'll go cross eyes left wing boards. Top of the server, Minnie goes cross eyes right wing boards there for Bessie. The shot did make it through. Blocked to the crease by Murray. Drag three on the right wing boards though by Shea Carey. Carey steps into the circle, fired the shot, blocked to the crease by Murray, wrapped up Kyle Quick with an all-encompassing octopus play. Still 17 seconds with a two-man advantage. 1:28 for the overall power play, 3:06 for the second period. It's a 3-1 Danville lead. Face to left of Harley White in the Danville goal. Nathan Margetz, who has the sole goal tonight for the Rumblebees in the face of lost that draw to Haney, but contained left point by Carl Munson. He'll saucer across to the right wing board for Margetz. Centering right in front for McGinnis. The shot! Whoa, that one launched over the top of the net and into the crowd. No further play. That time, Lee J. McGinnis, 6'4 and 287 pounds. He was right on the doorstep in an intimidating fashion. Uncovered, and as he spun and fired, that puck flew into the crowd. From the base of the neutral zone, Susie center circle finds his way in over the Danville line. Crunch, clamorous, being on ball on the boards by Murray, but contained left point by Munson. The shot is scored! Oh, Munson on the power play! 3 tons of glory! 3-2 Danville. This one counts.
Carl Munson came off the left wing boards at the top of the circle. Guns blazing. And a young court unholstered a humming howitzer on the Battle Creek power play. The time of the goal is 17-18. All three of the Rumble Beast goals this season by virtue of the man advantage, including both in the second period tonight. In fact, all three of the Rumble Beast goals this weekend in this season have been crammed into the middle frame. Carl Munson, who choreographed a three-goal hat-trick here a week ago tonight, to spearhead in the inter-squad game, Team Yellow's 6-2 victory over Team Black. Now from the face off, but the penalty box is now vacant. It's Rick Siegel behind the Rumblebee goal to our left to control it for Nicoletti. Nicoletti throw it to the line, contained on the left point by Palmerville. The shot that was knocked down in front by Nicoletti on the defense. Nicoletti saucers across on left wing at center Malcolm Zander. He was punished along the boards with a bruising check by Killian. Bobby Killian will ring it around the Battle Creek back wall to their right corner, stepping to a Champlain. He was checked there, controlled by Danville from the top of the right circle. The Barakoff screenshot did make it through. Knocked down by Siegel, contained straightaway center point by Palmerville with a shot. He raked it over top of the net. Rebound Kangaroos along the boards on the offensive left side. Now controlled by Nayer with a sharp angle shot. And that one sails over the glass into the crowd. No further play. It was Munson from Soucy at 18-18, and Benny Soucy now has been instrumental on all three of the Rumblebees' goals this season, all three on the power play. He has a power play goal last night and 2 second period assists tonight. It's a 3-2 shrinking Danville lead. Now the Rumblebees control in front of their own goal between the circles. Santelli's pass was knocked down the line by Hildebrand, centering it right in front on the doorstep for Brosnan, and he was given a rude jolt on the defense there by Soucy, who cracked him into the crossbar, knocking the net again out of place. No further play. 1:29 remaining, latter stages, second stanza, 3-2 Danville. It was Munson from Soucy on the power play at 18-18. From the base of inside the Battle Creek line, Rick Siegel on the left defense inadvertently will propel the puck the length of the ice. Icing the call against the Rumblebees. I don't think head coach Clint Hagmeier prefers that particular action. That forced the faceoff ladder stages, second stanza deep in the Rumblebee zone. Circle right of the goalkeeper, Jake Mullen from the draw. Center point ends or angles left wing corner for Tanner Hildebrand, who has 2 second period goals. Behind the goal for Justin Brosnan, who circles the net, powers his way to the left wing boards. He maintains control, muscling his way right back behind the goal. McElroy Scott scraped over his back as Brosnan centers it to the crease, and Mullen at the right post will freeze it. No further play. Exactly 1 minute remaining, second period. And it's a 3-2 evaporating Danville lead. The Rumblebees have trailed through 5 periods this series. They've not even had a tie so far. From the faceoff, Hildebrand into the left wing corner with a spinorama. Undresses Nicoletti the puck. He'll work his way in behind the goal. Deliver it right point for Killian. The screenshot deflected behind the goal by Champlain. Now John Champlain will cover it in congestion in front of his own goal and lead in the middle of center. Ryan Alves, he springs it over the Danville line for the left circle, centering right in front for Champlain, overtaken from behind by Brosnan. Back comes Danville. Now Palmerville on left wing at center. He'll curl in over that the Battle Creek line on the left wing board. He'll go cross-eyed to the right point for Killian. The screenshot right in front of the goal.
left circle. The shot, Mullen to save. Loose in front of the Tesserio. Shot right at Mullen the save, I believe. We have a penalty coming up for cross check. Late in the period, 1949, and Lee J. McGinnis the culprit. As Danville was storming, scraping, and swarming the Battle Creek goal. Clint Hagmeier is now being issued a stern reprimand, an admonishment by the referee, Chris Roy, as the Battle Creek head coach was animated, demonstrative, exercise, disputing the call on McGinnis. From the face up on the left point, it's controlled by Killian. Screenshot, and he plays the wide of mids. A court line of legs in front, up in the top of the left circle. Nahor fired, blocked by Nat at the horn, ending the second period. But Danville will begin the third period with power play time for the first minute, 49. For the duration of the Lee J. McGinnis cross-checking penalty at 19:29, and last night, the Dashers unleashed a three-goal unanswered third period barrage that cemented matters in the tune to the tune of a 7-1 domination of the Rumble Bees. Both teams trigger a pair of strikes in that second stanza. Both Danville goals were produced by Tanner Hildebrand, short-handed in equal strength, giving him a series high three goals through the two games. And poor Battle Creek, both their goals by virtue of the power play from Nathan Margetz and from the Swedish import right wing Carl Munson, all three of the Rumblebees' goals through the first five periods of their history have been with the extra band band. Two periods of play complete. Live from the rink, Battle Creek. It's Danville 3, the Rumblebees 2. We're on a 3-minute break. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
The greatest hits of all time. WFAT Battle Creek, AM 930, and 102.7, the Fat One.
Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher are attorneys at law. They've been proudly serving the greater Battle Creek community for over 75 years. They specialize in estate planning, probate and trust administration, corporate and business law, family law, and bankruptcy. If you need help, call us today at 269-965-7000. Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher, attorneys at law, serving the community for over 75 years and proud supporters of our pro hockey team, the Battle Creek Rumblebees.
The Griffin Grill and Pub is a classic tavern offering Irish American plates and many beers, plus live music. Located at 38 Michigan Avenue West, Griffin Grill and Pub serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Every day they strive to offer a great food and drink experience that sets them apart as being comfortable, fun, and original. Offering 36 draft beers from around the world, Griffin Grill and Pub is the only pub in Battle Creek with two cask-conditioned hand-pulled ales. They also have the reputation for the best fish and chips in town. 14 TVs, 5 dart lanes, and just a great atmosphere. Griffin Grill and Pub, downtown Battle Creek.
Jack Pearl's Team Sports is still the one great location for all the sporting equipment you need. Jack Pearl's has been here for a very long time, and they continue to serve our community with great friendly service. And they're always great prices. At Jack Pearl's, they customize products to show your team spirit. It's always the place to go to for all your team and sports apparel. Sporting goods, commercial printing, t-shirts, screen printing, clothing accessories, you name it, Jack Pearl's got it. Jack Pearl's Team Sports, always giving to our community. 26 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. JackPearl'sTeamSports.com.
JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill continues to be the number one destination in the Battle Creek area for juicy steaks and those delicious mouth-watering burgers. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill features those hard-to-find selections of whiskeys and bourbons. It's a comfort food restaurant with a great whiskey bar and great party entertainment. Every Friday and Saturday nights, there are two live bands beginning at 5 p.m. Car night on Fridays, bike night on Saturdays. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, 3965 West Dickman Road.
Graphics to Go is here to help organize all of your promotional needs. We promise to deliver better ideas, better timing, better budgets through our exceptional staff of industry professionals. We provide promotional products and services that go above and beyond making you and your business a major success. Graphics To Go can promise solutions before problems. They have merchandise apparel, mugs, glasses, office and desk accessories, and top tech equipment. At Graphics To Go, staying comfortable and complacent is simply not an option. Contact them at graphicstogoinc.com.
At Fox's Pizza Den in Battle Creek, they make the freshest, most delicious pizza, specialty hoagies, and mouthwatering scrumptious sides every day for their customers. They serve the absolute very best pizzas, strombolis, nearly world-famous wedgies, and gourmet pizzas. All of their meals are made with the finest ingredients and then baked to perfection. Always fast and friendly service. Fox's Pizza Den, Battle Creek. Order online for delivery or pick up at Fox's Pizza Den, BattleCreek.com. 269-979-9869.
Terry Ficarelli rejoining a live on the rink, Battle Creek, second intermission. Where's the Dashers? Rumblebees 2. The game referee by Chris Hoy. The linesman, Adam Fish. I should say the referees are Chris Hoy and Adam Fish. The linesman, Nick Schripp and Barry Mead. We want to remind you that you can stay up to date every day, even when there's not a game. It's the Rumblebees Hockey Update, Monday through Friday. Afternoon primetime drive time at 4:35 right here on your exclusive radio flagship home for Battle Creek Rumblebees FPHL Pro Hockey action. 102.7 FM the Bat One and 9:30 a.m. right here in Battle Creek. Two periods of play complete. A much better effort, much better performance from the Rumblebees tonight after 40 minutes. After they were humbled last night 7-1 in their grand opening night bonanza extravaganza, and the whole battle.
Experience to color services at an affordable price. Their hairstylists are some of the best trained in the business, specializing in haircuts for men. You get in and out while still receiving excellent service, including a hot towel at the end of every haircut. They'll listen to you and will recommend a style and products that will help you look and feel good. No appointment necessary and open 7 days a week. Check in online. Supercuts, the chosen hair salon of your Rumblebees.
Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza. Happy's Pizza is not your typical pizza place. Our dough is fresh, never frozen. Our pizza sauce is always homemade. Our veggies are hand-cut, fresh, and delicious. Your pizza is cooked to order just for you, and we deliver more than our great pizza. From ribs to chicken to seafood, Happy's offers delicious food made to order. Free delivery on all catering orders. 1180 Columbia Avenue West. Order online at happyspizza.com. Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza.
From the rink, Battle Creek, second intermission. Danville 3, the Rumblebees 2. Once third period action commences, as we embark on a critical, pivotal juncture of the contest, the Battle Creek club will be shorthanded for the first minute and 49 seconds. The balance of the DJ McGinnis cross-checking penalty that he ingested in 1949 late. Second period, his second minor penalty of the period. Want to remind you the Rumblebees are right back here at home next weekend, a Friday night, Saturday night. Combination of the rink, Battle Creek, they play host to Mentor. Face off both nights, 7:35. We're live from the rink, Battle Creek, our second intermission. It's Danville 3 of the Rumblebees 2. We'll be back. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
The Rumblebees are proud to highly recommend one of the premier restaurants in Battle Creek. Welcome to Kitchen Proper, 34 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. Kitchen Proper features scratch-made food with a primary focus on local
products. Innovation meets comfort food is their motto. Kitchen Proper offers a warm, inviting space with an open kitchen so their guests can watch the chefs in action. Items are made to order. Try their house favorites like fresh pasta with decadent sauces, fresh fish, hand-cut steaks, creamy risottos, and fresh, unique salads. Kitchen Proper downtown. Five-star all the way.
Jack Pearl's Team Sports is still the one great location for all the sporting equipment you need. Jack Pearl's has been here for a very long time, and they continue to serve our community with great, friendly service. And they're always great prices. At Jack Pearl's, they customize products to show your team spirit. It's always the place to go to for all your team and sports apparel. Sporting goods, commercial printing, t-shirts, screen printing, clothing accessories, you name it, Jack Pearl's got it. Jack Pearl's Team Sports, always giving to our community. 26 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. JackPearlsTeamSports.com.
Terry Cottrell, they're rejoining you live from the Ring Battle Creek. Second intermission, where it's Danville 3, the Rumblebees 2. Let's update you. There are four more games across the circuit tonight, and they're all the second and concluding games of two-game series at the same venues as last Pandora at Watertown last night. In a rare set of circumstances, the road team won all five games, including Danbury 7-1 dismissal of the Rumblebees here at the rink. Battle Creek elsewhere last night, Carolina topped Elmira in a 2-0 shutout. Columbus down Delaware 5-2 in overtime. Was 4-0 5, Danbury 4. And in Watertown, the Wolves were away, laid by Mentor 3-1. And that brings you right up to date on our FPHL scoreboard. Want to remind you that season tickets and single game tickets for the Rumblebees are on sale now. Call the Rumblebees at 269-243-5027 or check us out online at BHockey, that's BHockey.com, or any of the social media platforms at BC Rumblebees. Catch the Buzz Battle Creek. Let's buzz with the Rumblebees. Third period action is moments away from the rink. Battle Creek will open with the Rumblebees short in it with a first minute 49. The balance of the lead, Jay McGinnis, cross-checking penalty issued late in the second period of 19:49. Danville thus far tonight 0-3 on its power play. It's the Dashers 3, the Rumblebees 2. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Fat One.
At Jimmy John's, Freaky Fast makes it freaky fresh. Jimmy John's in Battle Creek makes Freaky Fast sandwiches using only the freshest ingredients. Quality is their way of life. That's why they spend 6 hours slicing all their natural meats and fresh vegetables and baking their fresh bread in-house every day. If you need delivery, your Battle Creek Jimmy John's has you covered. They also offer last-minute catering for any occasion. Stop by or order online at jimmyjohns.com. Jimmy John's with two locations, 5568 Beckley Road and downtown, 25 Capitol Avenue Southwest. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic is the official chiropractor of our pro hockey team, the Rumblebees. At Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, they take great pride in providing the finest chiropractic wellness care to their patients. They provide spinal correction utilizing gentle chiropractic techniques and corrective exercises where they teach their patients special exercises to help strengthen and correct their own unique problem. There's lifestyle advice, nutritional counseling, massage therapy, and spinal and postural screenings. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, 32 West Van Buren Street, the official chiropractor of the Rumblebees.
Terry Cottrell rejoining you live from the Rink Battle Creek. All set for third period action. It's the Dashers 3, the Rumblebees 2. Jake Mullen and Goldor left for the Rumblebees. His second straight start. Harley White in his first start of the season in Goldor. Right for Danville as you look into your radios. A 102.7 FM, the Bat One. We open with Danville on the power play with a first minute 49, and they control it center. Palmerville on left wing. Zigzag is clear of the rumbly line. He swoops him behind the goal, center into the right, so where Bronson Carey was in the way. He stripped him, but sees behind the goal by Hain. Back on the left point for Hildebrand. The shot, right on Mullen. This the rebound in the crease. And right there on the scene was Mooney to backhand it, Minnie to backhand it, back into the Danville zone. Backing it up on the defense, Palmerville circle the circle on the right side. Now for Bobby Killian and back the other way for Alex Palmerville. He'll launch it into the offensive right corner. Ayn is there to work it back to the right point for Hildebrand. Left point for Palmerville, the shot kicked off by Mullen. Rebound caressed behind the goal by Champlain, who raked it off the boards but contained left point by Palmerville right in front. Now for Brunson with a shadow stifle point blank range by Mullen. Rebound behind the goal. They jostle port vigorously there. Barrett free now by Nayer. Nayer angles blue line now. Left server Palmerville. The shot right out. Mullen closed the door. Analyzing rebound, relinquished to the right circle. Santelli is there. He'll propel the backhand to center. Control by Hildebrand on the counterattack with a rumbly line. He squares through the circle. Tanner Hildebrand swoops behind the goal and sets it up in the offensive right corner for Hain. Now Haynes back on right point for Hildebrand. The shot! Oh, pad save. Mullen rebound right board for Hain. The shot! He glanced it off the side of the net. Rebound right point for the pinch. Hildebrand with a shot. He scores. Henry Hildebrand with a hat trick. That's a power play goal, and it's a 4-2 Danville lead. Tanner Hildebrand has the scoring touch this weekend. He has the Midas touch, if you will. His third goal of the night. He has one at even strength. One short and it, and one on the power play. The time of the goal is 1:40. There are still 9 seconds remaining in the lead. Jay McInnes, flashing penalty. And once again, for the third time tonight, Danville has a two-goal lead. And Hildebrand has a series-high 4 goals. 3 tonight. On the base hub in front of the Danville, the rumble is goal. Margetts on right wing at center for Zander. He'll chase it down behind that Danville goal where he's wedged off of the squeeze by Murray. But contained left point by Siegel on the half wall. Now for Malcolm Zander. The shot! Oh, that one was just right of the short side. Rebound along the boards. Pinching right point, Nicoletti. There's a delayed penalty coming to Danville. David Nicoletti. Throw it behind the goal where it's covered on the defense. By Seth Enzor, the whistle sound from the referee, Adam Fish, and there will be a Danville penalty coming up, I believe, to Nick Gubbo. And we'll check on the call. I think it may be high sticking. The time is 2:21. The scoring play. We'll check it with Hildebrand, I believe. We'll check it. The credit of the Golden Nayer from Hildebrand. Jesse Nair apparently redirected. Off from the face on McInnes behind the goal. Right point for Santelli. Left point for Susie. Fanned on the shot. A break for Danville. Nayer will chase it down in the offensive left wing corner. Overpowered Susie. Toppled. Jesse Nair centering it. Glanced it off the side of the net to the right of Mullen. Loose in front, covered by Karn deep net. Down in on left wing, romping through center over the Danville line, overtaken from behind by Nayer, who dumped him. As Jesse Nayer returns it to Rattle Creek territory with a minute 20 for the power play. It was called 2 minutes for Heist, taking it 2:21. Now action halted behind the play. I think the puck deflected into the Rumblebee's bench at their blue line across the way from us. No further play was Nayer from Hill. Well, we'll check. It was a Hildebrand shot. So we'll check. The scoring is not correct there. The time of the goal, more importantly, was 1:40 to give Danville its third 2-goal lead of the night at 4-2. We have another Battle Creek penalty, I believe. This one, I think, to Lee J. McInnes. We'll check. We're on a break. 90-second break. Break in the action. Danville for the Rumblebees 2. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM. The Bat One.
The Griffin Grill and Pub is a classic tavern offering Irish American plates and many beers, plus live music. Located at 38 Michigan Avenue West, Griffin Grill and Pub serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Every day they strive to offer a great food and drink experience that sets them apart as being comfortable, fun, and original. Offering 36 draft beers from around the world, Griffin Grill and Pub is the only pub in Battle Creek with two cask condition hand-pulled ales. They also have the reputation for the best fish and chips in town. 14 TVs, 5 dart lanes, and just a great atmosphere. Griffin Grill and Pub, downtown Battle Creek.
Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher are attorneys at law. They've been proudly serving the greater Battle Creek community for over 75 years. They specialize in estate planning, probate and trust administration, corporate and business law, family law, and bankruptcy. If you need help, call us today at 269-965-7000. Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher, attorneys at law, serving the community for over 75 years and proud supporters of our pro hockey team, the Battle Creek Rumblebees.
JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill continues to be the number one destination in the Battle Creek area for juicy steaks and those delicious mouth-watering burgers. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill features those hard-to-find selections of whiskeys and bourbons. It's a comfort food restaurant with a great whiskey bar and great party entertainment. Every Friday and Saturday nights, there are two live bands beginning at 5 p.m. Car night on Fridays, bike night on Saturdays. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, 3965 West Dickman Road.
It's a 4-2 Danville lead. Now McRoyce comes from right point. Shoot.
Hit on.
And White grabbed that one. With the Rumblebees player Malcolm Zander right there. Lurking in the shadows of his doorstep. No further flight. Pacino Mini received it. The Rumblebees received it. 2 minute minor for 2 minute man on the ice. Pacino Mini serving it. The time, 3:07. Both teams a man short. Then they get to the Rumblebees power plays. 4-2 Danville is crossing, gains the Rumblebee line on left wing. Centering to the crease. Oh, and this is Zario. Backhanded and glanced it off the side of the net as he crowded the crease. Puck to the offensive left wing boards, controlled by Battle Creek. Carl Munson at his own line weaves his way through center at the Danville line. The shot! That was caught by White and he'll hold. No further play. In 9 seconds, the Danville penalty for high sticking to Nick Gaho will expire, and that will create a Danville partial power play for 46 seconds. Their power play is 1-4 tonight. The Rumblebees power play is 2-3. And it's a 4-2 Danville lead. From the face with a Danville line on left wing to Zoriero at center. Rink one on right wing now over the line for Bobby Killian. He'll pull his way in behind the goal. Working on Susie, he'll crunch him in the corner. They joust support vigorously. Killian cracked down Susie. The two tumble. Now Susie bounces back on the blades and secured at the line. Marie contains left point. Murray to the left wing boards on the half wall for Hain behind the goal with a chase and trace of Jesse Nair. Center into the crease. Whole block beautifully by Champlain. He'll seek refuge behind the goal. On retreat to cover up. Pull up towards his own line for Alves. Didn't expect it. Stolen by Hain. Hain shoots over top of the net. Hain chases his own rebound left corner. Centering a block between the edge marks and circles in front of the goal alertly. By John Champlain, who was on the scene to right flip the length of the ice. The penalties are over. Now McElroy Scott stole the puck in the offensive left circle. He shoots, he scores! Phoenix McElroy Scott pants a humdinger. 4-3 Danville. Phoenix McElroy Scott stepped out of the shadows up from the left circle dot. He uncorked a cannonading shot and ripped the cords upstairs. Far corner over the left shoulder of netminder Harley White. And the rookie from the University of Jamestown connects. The time of the goal is 5:21. And for the
third-time type of battling Rumblebees. They've shaved the deficit to his Kent Singleton. Now Munson over the line, centering it from right wing center point. Siegel was encumbered there, though, by Hayne. Puck to the Rumblebee line for Munson on right wing up towards that center. Carey beyond his reach. The length to the ice. Ice seen the call against Battle Creek. For the third time tonight, the Rumblebees have reduced the deficit to a scant singleton. It was McElroy's cut from Margetts. The time of the goal, we'll check it. From the faceoff, puck to the right corner, Dave Nicoletti is there. Nicoletti's pass tolling top of the left circle by Barakoff. The shot! That's right on. Mullen grabbed it. Action halted, I believe. We have a penalty coming up. Shea carrying a collision along the offensive, I should say, the Rumblebees left wing boards. Midway inside their own blue line, and he is injured. The Danville player, I believe that is Jesse Nair. And he will hobble, favoring his right leg to the Dancers bench. Meanwhile, Carey sits contritely in the penalty box. McElroy from Margetts. We'll have to check on the time. And now it's a Rumblebees penalty to Carey. 2 minutes for rupping. We have twin minors, both Carey and Nair. Both receive twin minors for rupping. The time, 5:56. It's a 4-3. Danville leading up. Palmerville from left point. He'll direct the left corner. Controlled there by DeSoriero. DeSoriero behind the goal. Now for Barakoff. Giving her up. Five by Bessie. Cracked him down. Corral down the right boards by Margetts, who has a goal and an assist tonight. Nathan Margetts at center. Was skated off by DeSoriero. Back comes Danville over the line on right wing is Bobby Killian. Shooting kicked off by Mullen. Kangaroos left point knocked down by Palmerville. Palmerville the left board for Killian. Top of the slapper. Hayne the shot. He scores! Brad Hayne on the screen shining again. Danville with a two-goal lead. It's 5-3. Mullen, I don't think Jake Mullen in the Battle Creek goal ever saw that shot that seemed to come out of nowhere by Fred Hayne. Had a goal and an assist last night. And again, Danville with a two-goal lead. Time of the goal was 6:34, and it comes with both teams a man short. 5-3 Danville. Now Susie to his own line on left wings, campers through center with the Danville line. He scores through the left circle, swoops in behind the goal, circle. Then it goes cross ice, left circle on McElroy's cut, centering it right through the crease. Champlain was wrapped up on the defense there by Antoine. A breakaway for Brosson over the line. He's in alone with a shot, and he scores. Justin Brosson on the breakaway, and it's 6-3 Danville. And the goals are coming fast and furiously now. Boston scores at 7:02. It was Hayne from Palmerville and Killian. At 6:34. And then 28 seconds later, it's Boston on a breakaway at 7:02. Both those Danville goals scored while both teams still skated a man short for another 46 seconds. It's 6-3 Dancers, their most sizable cushion of the night. Now Danville away again on left wing at center. Enzo over the line at the top of the circle goes back cross ice center points straight away for Gubbo. Back top left over Enzo. The shot pop aboard saved by Mullen. Rebound on the Rumblebees right board for Munson. Munson just drove across ice to an open wing. Covered in front of the goal by Murray. Pulled up by Munson, who bolts in front. He shoots. Oh, right on. Shrugged away right shoulder. Saved by Harley. White and back comes Danville. Both teams to the man short for 8 seconds. Now Patrick Selak through center on right wing. He gained the Rumblebee line over. Powered from behind by Munson. And back comes Battle of Creek. At center, Siegel on right wing. Shovel the back in into Danville territory on the left defense. Palmerville returns it to the Rumblebee line. Back comes Battle Creek on left wing. Karn deep nap through center. Charges in over the Danville line. Shooting right on. And White stepped out, sealed the angle, and squeezed it in the midsection. Dropping down on both batted pillows to secure it. No further play. Danville had 45 shots last night. They have 42 tonight. And they've outshot Battle Creek in this third period 12-1. Now from the faceoff, puck will be deep in the Danville zone. Carom on their left wing board for Jesse Nayer, and as he cleared the zone, the Rumblebees failed to contain it, and they're offside. 11:34 left, third period, 6-3. Anvil was Hayne from Palmerville and Killian at 6:34. Second goal in this series, one each night. 28 seconds later upon a breakaway was Bronson from Enzor and Murray at 7:02. Both those goals in their lightning-like sequence of 28 seconds came up both teams from man short. And Danville's lead is routed to a trifecta at 6-3. How many hits the Danville line? He'll amble into the left wing corner, wrapped up there by Killian. Who's punter on Gino Mini. They jostle port vigorously deep in the Danville left corner. Covered behind the goal by Killian. He'll swing to his own right corner and direct it to the Rumblebee line where Santelli on the right defense brushes the back end of the Danville zone. Dashers control Palmerville on the left defense up the board. That's center and Nayer. He shoots it across on right wing at the Rumblebee line. For Haney, right with the shot, and he ripped it wide. Rebound left corner for Nayer. He powers his way behind the goal and left to Theron upper Haney. He'll center one, comes back to the right point for Enzer. Enzer shoots, and McGinnis in the defensive left circle to Battle Creek. DJ McGinnis deflects it over the glass into the crowd. No further play. Adding an assist, I believe, on Battle Creek's second goal to Karn deep net. Now from the base up, Troy Murray barges him from left point. He was jolted by Nat. Nat starts out for Battle Creek. From center, he chips the puck into the Danville zone, but offside. On the left wing for Battle Creek was offside on the left side for the Rumblebees was Margetts. No further play. 10:22 left third period. It's a 6-3 Danville lead. From the faceoff at the center red line, Nicoletti on the right defense wrapped it off the boards in the Danville zone. Controlled there by Brawson. Brawson launches it to center, covered by Aaron Bessie for Battle Creek, directing it to the Danville line. Murray is there. He swings off the Jekka carry at center, squished at the back and behind the goal. Chased down in the offensive left corner by Hildebrand, encumbered by the combo of McElroy, Scott, and by Siegel, who leads in the middle. At center, Munson, it was behind him as the puck will squirm and back into the Battle Creek left wing corner, chased down by Gallo, who spins off the check of Aaron Bessie. Left wing corner, stripped second effort by Bessie. Bessie behind the goal for Nicoletti. David Nicoletti will bounce it off the boards into the Danville zone. Tracked down behind the goal by Killian. Killian leads at his own line on right wing there. for Danville's Marco Luciano. He will hoist it in behind the goal. Behind the play, we have a penalty coming up between the in the right front of the penalty boxes. Shea Carey, the culprit. He'll receive a two-minute minor for interference. Time 10:53. Shea Carey with his second minor of the period. So Danville, which has a power play that is 1-for-5 tonight and 6-for-14 in the series, will have an opportunity to duplicate their 7-goal output of last night. From the base out center point, Palmerville, right point for Hildebrand. On the right wing, half ball for Brawson with a sleek back pass behind the goal for Haynes. Right server Brawson, shooting! All in the save, it comes back. Left point for Hildebrand. Cross ice, top of the right server Brawson, loading the gun. The shot was blocked by Minnie Contino on the left point by Hildebrand. The shot was weak. Blocked by McElroy. Scott comes back. Left point for Hildebrand. He was upended by McElroy Scott, but not until he dished it to the left corner for Jesse Nayer. Left point for Hildebrand. Top of the right circle for Palmerville. Shooting. And St. Mullen comes back again. Left point for Hildebrand. Hildebrand screenshot. Brawson in front deflected it wide. Puck on the right board, settled by Haynes. Saucing across left point for Hildebrand. Cross ice now to the right point. Now for Palmerville. Center point straight away for Haynes. The shot, that's right on and Mullen. Well, the net obstructed and obscured view at the top of the crease. Will nestle it into his chest on that big hold and plays and Humble Bees press. No further play. It was Shane Carey, 2 minutes for tripping at 11:53 as a minute 3 to serve. And we have 8:10 left. Third period, 6-3 Dashers as they're on the precipice of a sweep of this inaugural weekend series for the Rumblebees. From the faceoff, puck behind the goal, control there by Desiriero. Down to Serio, steps low left, circle the shot, glanced off on that to Mullins right on his short side. Rebound comes back left point for Ansorio. Powers way into the corner, working on Nathan Margetts, who has a goal and assist. Tonight he'll work it now back left point for Desiriero. He'll go cross height to the right point for Troy Murray as Sanders steps out the pressure as Murray dishes to the top of the right circle. Allows circle the server to Zario. The shot right on. All in the save. The net out of place again. No further play. 23 seconds for the carry. Tripping transgression. 7:30 for the third period and a 6-3 Danville lead. They led 1-0 after the first period, 3-2 after 40 minutes. And for a second straight night, they've unleashed a 3-goal third period siege as they did last night in their 7-1 carnage of the Rumble Bees. Tonight, they've outscored Battle Creek 3-1 in the third period. Out from the base off, right in from the goal, Frank Santelli on the left defense from the circle will collect it and fire the length of the ice to penalty to Shea Carey is over. At the Danville line, Brunson. Across on the right side now for Killian. That one was pulling by Carey, who swings in behind that Danville goal. On rapid recovery, Killian crunched him as Champlain cracked down Brunson in the offensive left corner for the Rumblebees. Brunson bounces back on the blades and overpowers Champlain. Corrals the puck, and arc it into the Battle Creek zone. On the left defense, it's Aaron Berry. Cross ice on the right defense for Minnie. Gino Minnie through center at the Danville line with a shot, and White with a right shoulder will shrug it over the glass into the crowd in that Danville goal to our right. No further play. 6:28 remaining, third period. It's a 6-3 Danville lead. For Danville tonight, Tanner Hildebrand has 2 goals and an assist to spark their assault for the Rumblebees. Nathan Margetts has a goal and an assist. His goal on a power play.
Carl Munson has a power play goal. And Vinny Susie has a goal and an assist for Battle Creek in this contest tonight. Phoenix McElroy Scott has caged the Singleton in this third period for the Rumblebees. That's his first ever pro goal for the rookie from the University of Jamestown. The faceoff, once play resumes, will be circle left of Harley White in the Danville goal. We invite you to stay tuned for the Rumblebees postgame show immediately following tonight's action. Again, we want to remind you, the Rumblebees are right back home here next Friday and Saturday nights at 7:35. Right here, the site, the rink, Battle Creek. They'll play host both nights to the Mentor Icebreakers. Carndeep Nant in the faceoff of the Rumblebees. And he will oppose Patrick Zeebach. They present arms, one by Nant. He'll step to the right boards and venture into the corner. He jammed there by Ensor. Ferreted free, though, by Malcolm Sander. Sander down, bounced it to the right point for Mini. Now Mini left point for Quick, and Quick failed to hold it in for the Rumblebees. Right in front of the Danville bench, across the way for Bus. At the Rumblebees left point, no further play. So it's 6-10, left third period. They will produce a faceoff outside the Danville line, across the way from us. Battle Creek's third period, left wing in front of the Danville bench. It's 6-3 Dashers. From the faceoff, there's a delayed penalty coming up now to Danville. As Chino Mini will corral the puck in his own zone. Set it up on the right boards behind the goal for Aaron Best with a sleek back pass. Pining Mini in the corner. Mini spins off the check of Levi Armstrong back behind the goal for Nat. Iron deep Nat now back. Kyle sets it up for Mini right side of the goal. Mini on right wing in his own line for Carl Munson. Munson just banked it off the board to the Danville line where Troy Murray on the defense. Les Sosa. There prompts the whistle from the referee. And Levi Armstrong will be tagged with a two-minute minor for slashing. Armstrong served two minors last night for the victorious Dashers. Armstrong, 2 minutes for slashing at 14:27. Armstrong, 2 minutes slashing at 14:27. Rumblebees power play 2-for-4 tonight and 3-for-10 in the series. The other 4 goals this season by way of the power play in this series. From the base of on the blue line, contained on the left point there by Siegel. Cross ice to the right point for Nat. Nat sets it up right wing corner of McGinnis. McGinnis now thunders it to the side of the goal. Right point for Nicoletti. Right wing boards now for Nathan Margetts. Now he let it left set up on the elbow for Nance. Right point for Margetts, who panned down the shot. Controlled by the seizing stick of Hain at his own line on left wing. And Fred Hain will drift it the length of the ice. Behind the goalie, Hildebrand dragged it off the stick of Margetts, but from the his own left wing corner, Siegels is there to recapture. Rick Siegel at his own line on right wing, stepped out the center, crunched along the boards by Brawson, hovered back in the Rumblebee zone on retreat by Nicoletti. David Nicoletti at his own line will step out the center, crossing the Danville line. He'll button hook, dishing left circle. McGinnis caught in the skates. And from his own right wing board, Jesse Nair will drift the puck to center. Controlled by Mini on the quick counterattack on right wing, gaining the bad draft, the Danville line. He throw it along the board, contained on the left point there by Bessie, who throw it in behind the goal. Covering on the defense there is Alex Palmerville, and he will rake it the length of the ice. Still 25 seconds with a power play, 3:56 for the third period at 6-3 Danville. Now Kyle Quick steps on the gas at center. He streaks in over the Danville line. Dropped at center point for Mooney. Left point now for Bessie. Couldn't hold it in. Back comes Danville at the center stripe. Left of the circle. It's Hain to Spinorama. And direct it back in behind the goal with a penalty
firing to Armstrong. Danville controls it. It's a home line mini on the right defense at center over the Danville line on the right board for Carndeep Nat. He was encumbered by Gallo, who sends Luciano's creaking in over the to Battle Creek line on left wing. He'll drop it back left point for Murray, angling right wing corner for Selak. He was shouldered by Santelli, covered in front of the goal by Battle Creek. Carl Munson, and he's away. Munson through center had the puck, snake off his tick, pick behind the goal. Whistle sounds on the icing call against Danville. No further play. 2:57 remaining, third period. Danville on the verge of completing the sweep of the two-game week in this homestand series to inaugurate Rumblebeast Pro Hockey history in Battle Creek. As the Dashers lead it 6-3, they vouch for the Rumblebeast 13-4 in the series. From the faceoff, puck control between the circles in front of his own goal on the defense by Troy Murray, sending it to the Battle Creek line. Siegel on the right defense in the middle of the center, lead Jay McGinnis, who muscles his way over that Danville line. Overtaken on the defense by Killian. Whistle sounds. I believe that the Rumblebees are guilty of a hand pass on the offensive right boards to our right. Inside Danville territory, no further play. Shots on goal tonight. Danville 48. Battle Creek 20. Last night it was Danville 45. Rumblebee 17. Danville with 93 shots on goal in this series. The Rumblebees have returned only 39. From the base hop deep in the Rumblebee zone, this time it's the Dashers guilty of the glove pass. That brings action or abrupt cessation. And we'll produce a face-off outside the Rumblebee blue line. 2:22 left. 6-3 Dashers. They control the center stripe on right wing. Bobby Killian stroked it into the Battle Creek zone. Hinging back behind the goal. Last toward Bessie. Dish on the right board for Munson. Caught on left wing. At a center for Nicoletti, who stroked it behind the goal. Roll blocked by the barricading stick of Harley White. White around the board. This pass was halted there by the Rumblebees. McElroy Scott. He delivered it back behind the goal on it there with a breakaway. His name here over the line. The shot right through the crease. Puck to the offensive right wing corner of Barakov. He was giving her up right on the defense. Shed the check to a Nicoletti. Now he'll control the left point for Murray. Murray's shot was blocked at the top of the circle by Munson, who stepped out to pressure. Murray with another shot from left point. Threw a screen, and that was high and wide. Puck along the boards on the Rumblebee's left side, covered by Bessie. He pivots and chips it to center. At center, Murray on left wing steps in over the Rumblebee line, wedged off of the squeeze along the board by Munson. Controlled in front of the crease by Gino Mini on the defense. Mini swept it to the blue line. Murray Gonzalez, left point. Murray fired the shot, blocked in front by Santelli, who wrapped up Silak with a minute left in the third period. Now loose to the top of the slot. That time from there, Luciani fired the shot. He whistled it over top of the net. Puck behind the Rumblebee goal, and from there on the defense, it's Gino Mini to lace it into Danville territory. Danville defense will control from behind the goal line. Retreated Seth Enzor. Now tailgating on his bumper is Carnap Neep as he drove it into the zone. Controlled by Battle Creek Siegel. Rick wanted left wing at center as Malcolm Zander, and he crossed the Danville line. He blew a tire, and the puck deflects over the glass into the Danville bench. No further play. 21 seconds remaining. Danville with 50 shots tonight. From the faceoff, Siegel on left point, the screen shot, and he boomed it wide. Rebound along the boards on the Danville left side, controlled by Nair.
Nair will just sail the puck into the Rumblebee's zone where Siegel is chased behind the goal by Barakoff. The horn will sound. This hockey game is over. And the Danville Dashers will finish with the worst record in the FPHL last season. Enters this season, launches it in grand style, grand fashion. They complete the sweep of the week, the two-game weekend series, and really sabotages their debut. And the return of pro hockey in Battle Creek in the form of the Rumblebees. Anvil wins 7-1 last night with 3 third period goals and 5 power play goals. Tonight, 3 more third period goals, 1 on the power play. Battle Creek 3 times did shear the deficit to Wisconsin-Singleton before they succumbed for a second straight night to a Danville 3 goal third period uprising. The final quarter net for the rink, Battle Creek and Saturday Night Hockey. The Danville Dashers 6, the Battle Creek Rumblebees 3. Stay tuned. The Rumblebees 4th period program coming up next. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Fat One.
WFAT Battle Creek, W274AQ Battle Creek, AM 930 and 102.7, the Fat One.
At Fox's Pizza Den in Battle Creek, they make the freshest, most delicious pizza, specialty hoagies, and mouthwatering scrumptious sides every day for their customers. They serve the absolute very best pizzas, strombolis, nearly world-famous wedgies, and gourmet pizzas. All of their meals are made with the finest ingredients and then baked to perfection. Always fast and friendly service. Fox's Pizza Den, Battle Creek. Order online for delivery or pick up at Fox's Pizza Den, BattleCreek.com. 269-979-9869. Did you have the first Fleetwood Mac Rumors album? I wore out my first one. Fleetwood Mac, one of the best-selling bands of all time. We couldn't get enough. They took 50 years of music and made their Don't Stop collection. They're making a final stop of Fleetwood Mac's world tour in Vegas, too. You can catch them November 16th and all weekend long. 102.7 The Fat One is showcasing Fleetwood Mac. It's magnificent.
How to go to the end of the game close, Isaac.
Score! Yabba-dabba-doo!
Hey, Sue!
Hoops-shakalaka! Hoops-shakalaka!
Battle Creek Rumblebees FPHL Pro Hockey Action on 102.7 The Fat One and AM 930 is presented by Allegra Marketing Printmail, by Barista Blues Cafe, by Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, Fox's Pizza Den, Graphics to Go, Jimmy John's, Jack Pearl's Team Sports, Happy's Pizza, Vanderbort, Kristen Fisher, Attorneys at Law, Kitchen Proper, JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, Griffin Grill and Pub, by the Rink Battle Creek, Supercuts, and by the Cricket Club. Stay tuned, the Rumblebees post-game report with Terry Ficcarelli coming up next, right here on your exclusive radio home for the Rumblebees, Battle Creek's 102.7 The Fat One.
Isaac, let's go. We've got a spot set here.
It's the best lunch place in town and right in the heart of downtown Battle Creek. The Barista Blues Cafe, 91 Michigan Avenue West, features a fantastic menu of American and Italian cuisine. This place is a diamond in the rough. Barista Blues Cafe is a great place to grab a quick bite or a quick lunch, and they always have great daily lunch specials. Enjoy a hot cup of coffee, great conversation, and a friendly smile. Locally owned and operated, Barista Blues Cafe is always focused on customer satisfaction. Barista Blues Cafe, come on in and join the fun.
Graphics to Go is here to help organize all of your promotional needs. We promise to deliver better ideas, better timing, better budgets through our exceptional staff of industry professionals. We provide promotional products and services that go above and beyond. making you and your business a major success. Graphics To Go can promise solutions before problems. They have merchandise apparel, mugs, glasses, office and desk accessories, and top tech equipment. At Graphics To Go, staying comfortable and complacent is simply not an option. Contact them at graphicstogoinc.com.
Isaac, I need a post-game show intro, pal. Come on. Let's go, spots. We got spot breaks here until the post-game show open.
Is a full-service marketing print mail communications company based right here in Battle Creek. We help companies solve simple or complex problems through our expertise, creative solutions, and can-do attitude. Allegra Marketing Print Mail provides marketing, consulting, graphic design, and sales promotion products for small and medium-sized businesses, nonprofits, and institutions. Let us get to know your business. Contact us today at 269-968-2403 or at allegramarketingprint.com.
Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza. Happy's Pizza is not your typical pizza place. Our dough is fresh, never frozen. Our pizza sauce is always homemade. Our veggies are hand-cut, fresh, and delicious. Your pizza is cooked to order just for you, and we deliver more than our great pizza. From ribs to chicken to seafood, Happy's offers delicious food made to order. Free delivery on all catering orders. 1180 Columbia Avenue West. Order online at happyspizza.com. Make everyone happy with Happy's Pizza.
At Jimmy John's, Freaky Fast makes it freaky fresh. Jimmy John's in Battle Creek makes Freaky Fast sandwiches using only the freshest ingredients. Quality is their way of life. That's why they spend 6 hours slicing all their natural meats and fresh vegetables and baking their fresh bread in-house every day. If you need delivery, your Battle Creek Jimmy John's has you covered. They also offer last-minute catering for any occasion. Stop by or order online at jimmyjohns.com. Jimmy John's with two locations, 5568 Beckley Road and downtown, 25 Capitol Avenue Southwest.
Jack Pearl's Team Sports is still the one great location for all the sporting equipment you need. Jack Pearl's has been here for a very long time, and they continue to serve our community with great friendly service. And they're always great prices. At Jack Pearl's, they customize products to show your team spirit. It's always the place to go to for all your team and sports apparel. Sporting goods, commercial printing, t-shirts, screen printing, clothing accessories, you name it, Jack Pearl's got it. Jack Pearl's Team Sports, always giving to our community. 26 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. JackPearlsTeamSports.com.
Battle Creek is catching the pro hockey buzz. This is the Rumblebees fourth period program on 102.7 The Fat One and AM 930. With the game's wrap-up, the voice of the Rumblebees, here's Terry Ficarelli.
Back at the rink, Battle Creek in downtown our town. This is the Rumblebees fourth period program for this Saturday night as the visiting Danville Dashers really sabotage the Rumblebees' debut, their premier appearance as a bona fide professional hockey franchise in the FPHL. Tonight, the Dashers duplicate their third period exploits of last night as they trigger a trifecta of strikes and cement this one to complete the sweep of the week and the two-game series over the Rumblebees. However, tonight, we saw a vastly improved Rumblebees aggregation nation under the direction of head coach Clint Hagmeier as three times in the contest the Rumblebees narrowed the deficit to a scant singleton twice on power play goals as center Nathan Margett spurred the assault with a goal and an assist. Carl Munson also offered a power play goal, a singleton in the third period cage from McElroy Scott as the Rumblebees three times came close before ultimately succumbing to Danville's superiority and supremacy again in the third period tonight. Danville outshot the Rumblebees 50-20 tonight, 95-39 in the series, and in the third period again, that was the bugaboo for Battle Creek. Last night, the Rumblebees in that fateful final frame were outshot 21-8 tonight by a massive margin of 20-3, two periods combined. Rumblebees outshot by the Dashers 41 28-11. Two goals for Tanner and Aldergren tonight. Spark the victory attack. The next quarter night on Lake Battle Creek on Saturday night of hockey. Hockey night in Battle Creek. Saturday night crow. The Danville Dashers 6, the Battle Creek Rumblebees 3. Back to wrap it up after we pause for a moment. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Fat One.
Battle Creek Family Chiropractic is the official chiropractor of our pro hockey team, the Rumblebees. At Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, they take great pride in providing the finest chiropractic wellness care to their patients. They provide spinal correction utilizing gentle chiropractic techniques and corrective exercises where they teach their patients special exercises to help strengthen and correct their own unique problem. There's lifestyle advice, nutritional counseling, massage therapy, and spinal and postural screenings. Battle Creek Family Chiropractic, 32 West Van Buren Street, the official chiropractor of the Rumblebees. The Rumblebees are proud to highly recommend one of the premier restaurants in Battle Creek. Welcome to Kitchen Proper, 34 Michigan Avenue West, downtown. Kitchen Proper features scratch-made food with a primary focus on local products. Innovation meets comfort food is their motto. Kitchen Proper offers a warm, inviting space with an open kitchen so their guests can watch the chefs in action. Items are made to order. Try their house favorites like fresh pastas with decadent sauces, fresh fish, hand-cut steaks, creamy risottos, and fresh, unique salads. Kitchen Proper, downtown. Five-star, all the way.
Terry Piccarelli rejoining you live from the rink, Battle Creek, downtown in our town. This is our Rumblebees fourth period program on this Saturday night as Danville completes the sweep of the two-game weekend series, sabotaging the Rumblebees in the inaugural weekend. The final tonight, the Dashers 6, the Rumblebees 3. The game refereed tonight by Chris Hoy and Adam Fish. The linesman, Nick Sharippa and Barry Mead. In the opening period, the Rumblebees stayed the steady course. However, 12:07 on a miscue in front of the Rumblebees goal, the advantageous, the opportunistic Danville Dashers exploited it. It was the Russian Artem Barakov who fired his second goal of the series, one each night. Barakov from Jesse Nair, second assist for A.J. Tussariero. Time of the goal, 12:07, first period. And for a second successive night, Danville had stung the Rumblebees with the game's first goal, catapulting into a 1-0 lead at the first intermission. Through two first periods in this series, the Dashers outscored the Rumblebees 3-0. They outshot them 14-7 first period tonight, 13-4 last night, for a composite total of 27-11. Barakov from Nair and A.J. Tesoriero. Time of the goal, 12:07, lifting the visitors into a 1-0 lead, a lead they never relinquished. In that opening period, Danville outshot Battle Creek 14-7. The only penalty in the period was tagged to the Rumblebees in Carndeep net for tripping at 15-16. The Rumblebees penalty killing unit maligned and certainly shredded last night to the tune of 5 Danville power play goals, held the Dashers' potent power play at bay in the opening period of play. Second period, early at the 49-second mark, Danville playing assistant coach and leading scorer Justin Brosson was tagged with a tripping penalty at the 49-second mark. On their initial power play endeavor of the night, the Rumblebees power play boomerang to the tune of Danville's first shorthanded goal this season, likewise the first surrendered by Battle Creek. 1:10 the time, when Tanner Hildebrand, who propelled a pair of goals last night, struck. Hildebrand from Hain at 1:10, shorthanded strike. Early moments, second period at 1:10, as the Dashers' lead had grown to 2-0. However, at 8:05, Battle Creek gallant in defeat tonight, riposted with a power play goal of their own. Hildebrand was serving an interference infraction issued at 6:41 when Nathan Margetz
who was lurking in the shadows at the right edge of the crease, converted on a Vinny Susi centering pass that the latter orchestrated from low in the offensive left circle. Margaret's first from Susi and McGinnis at 8:05. The second goal of their history by the Bumblebees, both on the power play, both third in the second period. They achieved the deficit to a singleton at 2-1. However, 3:09, make it 3:11 later, 11:16. Hildebrand scored his second goal tonight from Enzor, 11:16, the time on a screen shot. Danville is away on right wing. Nick Hollowitz center was tripped from behind by Margetz, who was tailgating on his bumper. Margetz from center circle stripped back into the Danville zone. On the right defense, Killian circled.
And it was
again from Murray in the middle. Center Zylock gaining the Battle Creek line, converged on by both Susi and Minnie on the defense. And it's Gino Minnie to control in his own zone.
Circle
on the left defense for Susi.
Susi holds.
Susi up to the board. That's center and upper
22.
It was Susi again acting to roll the power play playmaker extraordinaire from the left side. He slipped the sweet centering pass to the rookie Swede, Carl Munson. Munson from the top of the circle bolt to the top of the slot, guns blazing. He ripped the cord for his first goal as a pro. Munson from Susi and Karn deep net at 18-18. Both teams have traded a pair of goals in period two. And for the second time tonight, Battle Creek had sheared the deficit to a scant singleton after 40 minutes of 3-2. The first three goals scored by the Rumblebees this season, and in their history, crammed into the second period in all three by virtue of the power play. Danville outshot the Rumblebees for a fifth straight period in this series in period two tonight. 16-10, seven minor penalties were meted out. Four to the Dashers and three to the Rumblebees. Paddle Creek, 2-for-3 on its second period power play. Danville in the middle, frame 0-for-2. The third period was the demise of the Rumblebees tonight. At 1:40 from a base hop deep in Battle Creek territory. For a second time tonight, Danville netted a goal off a base hop win in the Battle Creek zone. Hildebrand from right point uncorked the sizzler. Jesse Nayer flashed the crease, converting. Nayer's first from Hildebrand and Hain. The time of the goal, 1:40. That was a power play goal, too. With a spillover cross-checking penalty, Pepe fell. The right wing, the 287-pound Leviathan, Lee J. McGinnis, who was tagged with his second minor of the second period. Late in that stands at 19:49. It was Danville's only power play goal tonight, but this was the game-winning thrust against the Rumblebees and their sixth man advantage strike that they stoked in this series. Nayer from Hildebrand and Ain at 1:40 on the power play. And Danville had its third two-goal grip on the night at 4-2. But the Rumblebees were stout, they were resilient, and they bounced back again. This time at the 5:20 mark when McElroy Scott stole the puck. He stepped out of the shadows in the offensive left circle, and from the left circle dot, he zinged the shot and rifled it behind goaltender Harley White. For the rookie of the University of Jamestown, McElroy Scott is first as a pro. Marr gets the assist, 5:20 the time, and for the third time tonight, the Rumblebees had shaved the deficit to a single goal at 4-3, but that's as close as Battle Creek would get. At 6:34, a minute and 14 seconds later, with both teams playing a man short, 2-to-Quinn to Danville, Jesse Nayer, and Battle Creek, Shea Carey for high sticking at 5:56. 6:34 the time. Haynes scored his second of the series from Palmerville and Killian, and 28 seconds later on a breakaway. Cross and notch this third of the series from Ensor and Murray. Two goals, 28 seconds apart. While both teams remain short, Peck completed the scoring and the second consecutive three-goal third period assault by Danville, who outscored Battle Creek in the second period in this series 4-3. In the third period, 6-1. And for the series, 13-4. They win it tonight, 6-3. They outshot the Rumblebees in the third period by a lopsided margin of 20-3. Last night, they outshot them in period 3, 21-8. For a combined third period total of outshooting the Rumblebees in the third period of a massive 41-11. For the game tonight, shots on goal, Danville 50, the Rumblebees 20. In the two-game series combined, Danville outshot the Rumblebees 95-39. In the game, there were 14 minor penalties for 28 minutes, equally assessed, 7 penalties for 14 minutes for both clubs. Rumblebees' power play was 3-for-5, make it 2-for-5 tonight. They were 3-for-12 in the series, an excellent 25% proficiency rating. And the Battle Creek Rumblebees' power play was 3-for-7 in the series for 42.9% proficiency rating. Danbury's power play 1-for-5 tonight, 6-for-14 in the series. For Danville tonight, it was Tanner Hildebrand with two goals and an assist. Jesse Nair, the game-winning goalman, and assist. Freddie Hain had a goalman and assist tonight as well for the Victors. For the Vanquished Rumblebees, Nathan Marr gets a goalman and assist. Singletons by Carl Munson on a power play. And Phoenix McElroy Scott, two assists for Vinny Seuss, who has 3 points in his first two games on the Rumblebees defense. One power play goal and two power play assists for the native from Pittsburgh. Jake Mullen faced 95 shots in the Battle Creek Cole this weekend. He did rebuke 82 of them of the 95. He takes the loss, and Harley White captured the conquest in this contest tonight for victorious Danville. For the Rumblebees, they're 0-2, Danville 2-0. Next up, a weekend series also at home here as the Rumblebees play host to Mentor. Again, the final, Danville 6, the Rumblebees 3. Back with more after we pause for a moment. This is Rumblebees Hockey on 102.7 FM, the Bat One.
Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher are attorneys at law. They've been proudly serving the greater Battle Creek community for over 75 years. They specialize in estate planning, probate and trust administration, corporate and business law, family law, and bankruptcy. If you need help, call us today at 269-965-7000. Vandervoort, Christ, and Fisher, attorneys at law, serving the community for over 75 years and proud supporters of our pro hockey team, the Battle Creek Rumblebees.
The Griffin Grill and Pub is a classic tavern offering Irish American plates and many beers, plus live music. Located at 38 Michigan Avenue West, Griffin Grill and Pub serves breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Every day they strive to offer a great food and drink experience that sets them apart as being comfortable, fun, and original. Offering 36 draft beers from around the world, Griffin Grill and Pub is the only pub in Battle Creek with two cask-conditioned hand-pulled ales. They also have the reputation for the best fish and chips in town. 14 TVs, 5 dart lanes, and just a great atmosphere. Griffin Grill and Pub, downtown Battle Creek.
Terry Ciccarelli rejoining you live from Rink Battle Creek. This is our Rumblebees fourth period program on this Saturday night. The Dashers complete the sweep of Battle Creek. They prevail tonight 6-3. The three stars for tonight's game. Star number 3 had 1 goal and 1 assist for the Vanquished Rumblebees, center Nathan Margetz. Star number 2 had a goal and an assist, including the game-winning goal on an early third period, a power play for Danville. Center Jesse Nair, and the number one star with 3 points tonight. Two goals, one assist, including a short and a goal right wing, Tanner Hildebrand. Those are your three stars for tonight's game. For the Rumble Beast tonight, they deactivated center Eli Kinsman, while left wing Cliff Ogle served a one-game suspension. For the Rumble Beast, Clint Hagmeyer reactivated. Left wings Malcolm Sander and Kyle Quick both making their debuts tonight for Battle Creek. Ryan Alvis apparently suffered an undisclosed injury. We did not see him after the midway point of the second period tonight from head coach Clint Hagmeyer. In the meantime, Danville skated with its same lineup that registered their resounding 7-1 victory last night at the expense of the Rumble Bees. Next up, the Mentor Icebreakers, a pair of games next weekend. Next Friday and Saturday night, 7:35, face off both nights at the rink, Battle Creek. Rumble Bees tickets are available at the Rumble Bees offices located right here at the rink, Battle Creek, or call us direct 269-243-5027. Check us out online at bhockey.com or any of the social media platforms at BC Rumble Bees. This program, you know, you can stay up to date every day, even when there's not a game. The Rumble Bees hockey update comes your way Monday through Friday afternoon primetime drive time at 4:35 right here on your exclusive radio home for Rumble Bees Pro Hockey Action, 1027 FM, the Bat One, 930 AM, right here in Battle Creek, and all season long. You can also listen to all the play-by-play home and away, all the way with the Rumble Bees. We stream it live. You can catch the live stream on 1027WFAT.com. And then click on the listen now, and you're tuned up and tuned in for all the electrifying spellbinding action of Battle Creek Rumble Bees FPHL Pro Hockey Action. Again, the final, Danville 6, the Rumble Bees 3. Back with final notes after we pause for a moment. This is Rumble Bees Hockey on 1027 FM, the Bat One.
JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill continues to be the number one destination in the Battle Creek area for juicy steaks and those delicious mouth-watering burgers. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill features those hard-to-find selections of whiskeys and bourbons. It's a comfort food restaurant with a great whiskey bar and great party entertainment. Every Friday and Saturday nights, there are two live bands beginning at 5 p.m. Car night on Fridays, bike night on Saturdays. JB's Whiskey Old Style Grill, 3965 West Dickman Road.
The Rumble Bees want you to stop by the Cricket Club, Battle Creek's premier bar. The Cricket Club features over 50 beers on tap on the longest wooden bar in the state of Michigan at over 90 feet long. The Cricket Club is especially well known for their handcrafted cocktails, as well as their specialty pizzas, other food items, and the broadest selection of spirits in town. The Cricket Club is conveniently located at 36 West Michigan Avenue downtown. The Cricket Club is the hive for the Rumble Bees.
Well, we'll take it back. Terry Ficcarelli rejoining you live from the rink, Battle Creek. This is our Rumble Bees fourth period program for tonight as Danville completes the sweep of the two-game series here. Tonight, the decision, the Rumble Bees 6-3. Let's update that FPHL scoreboard. We have three more games to report tonight. First in Danbury for the Hattricks, making their debut this season. For a second consecutive night, edged by a scant single goal by Port Huron. Last night in overtime, the Prowlers prevailed 5-4 tonight. It's Port Huron 4, Danbury 3. That's a final. Elsewhere tonight, we'll check it here tonight. Delaware drubs Columbus 8-2 to salvage a split of that two-game series in Delaware. Last night, Columbus decision Delaware ruining the Thunder's debut as a bona fide FBHL franchise, 5-2. Tonight, Delaware certainly exacts retribution as they absolutely dismantle the Columbus River Dragons, 8-2. Elsewhere tonight in Elmira, remarkably, for a second consecutive night, the defending Commissioner Cup champions, the Carolina Thunderbirds, shut out the Enforcers for a second consecutive night by a replica result of 2-0. These two teams vied in the Commissioner Cup finals last season that saw Carolina defeat Elmira. Tonight, like last night, it was Commissioner's Cup revisited from last spring. And remarkably, for a second consecutive night, Elmira is planked on home ice by an identical result as Carolina prevails 2-0. And in Watertown tonight, the Wolves gain a split of their two-game homestand series with Mentor as they trade 3-1 victories. Icebreakers doused the Wolves last night 3-1. Tonight, a reversal of roles. Watertown 3, Mentor 1. That's a final. That brings you right up to date on our FPHL scoreboard. The league is idle on Sunday. Let's update the standings before we exit tonight. First, in the East Division, at the moment, it's Mentor with 2 points, Delaware with 2 points. I should say Mentor and Watertown each with 2 points. Danbury with a... We'll try to start over again, and I apologize. Delaware, Mentor, Watertown, all with 2 points. Danbury with 1, Elmira with none. West Division, Carolina with 6 points. Danville, 6 points. Port Huron, 5 points. Then it's Columbus, 3 points. Paddle Creek, the Rumblebees have yet to begun. Those are your standings at the conclusion of the opening week of the 10th anniversary season of the FPHL. Our engineer tonight at Flagship Central, Isaac Greenwich, always a pleasure to work with him. Thank you, sir. Our statistician tonight, the lovely and talented Jet. The talent on this Battle Creek Rumblebees hockey broadcast is compensated for by the Rumblebees Hockey Club. Again, the finals quarter night for the rink, Battle Creek and Saturday Night Hockey. The Danville Dashers 6, the Battle Creek Rumblebees 3. This is Terry Piccarelli.